Hi everyone, welcome to Taps and Chats. I'm here with Simone and Seth. We are getting a whole bunch of little frogs today. So, why frogs? I'm sure they want to know.
I guess frogs are just my life.
Frogs are life?
So, I study water, ironically, and I've always loved frogs.
Okay. When you say you study water, like...
I study.
Okay, so you finished it. All right. And how long were you studying water for?
4 years.
I didn't think it would take that long to learn about water, but well, I know.
Yeah. I guess it's more the stuff that's in the water.
So like microbiology sort of shtick.
Yeah, I don't want to think about it.
The government isn't going to get in the water.
Okay.
I think frogs has always been all my life. You know, always loved them.
Did you have pet frogs, or you just have like frogs?
We had a pet frog.
We had.
We named him Roberto.
Roberto? Yeah, that sounds good.
Except either he disappeared or we just didn't see him anymore.
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah.
Yes, good.
But it grew up on like middle of nowhere, so there's always lots of frogs around. And when I see frogs, I pick it up.
Yeah, we had a frog incident happen at our house not long ago. A couple of green tree frogs decided to live in our toilet.
When you go out west, that's like a common thing.
Yeah. I was just like, why would you choose there of all places?
Yeah, I've seen that.
Okay.
I'm lucky that I found it, because if the wife had found it, she would have probably jumped through the wall.
No pun intended.
Yeah.
What?
Not as bad as we're bitches be tripping.
Thanks, Thomas and Yakos.
Mm-hmm. Oh, dad jokes are pretty much my life.
When I get asked to tell a joke, it's horrible.
Mm-hmm.
I go straight up to the, why did the frog's car get pulled away?
Why?
He got towed. They just look at me like, why?
Why did, what do you call a million male rabbits walking backwards?
What?
A receding hairline. Yeah. That's pretty much like my entire humor. It's just dad jokes and puns.
My entire humor is just things that are allowed to be said most of the time.
It's dark.
Yeah, just dark humor. Just like, you need to carry a little sensor button around with you. Or just like walk around with a constant black bar across your mouth.
What am I allowed to say?
It's my question. How bad?
Well, if it's really that bad, I can cut it. Or I can go on like a Patreon thing where it's like explicit only.
Oh, sweet. I'll get you money.
Who wants to hear Seth's jokes? Number one.
All right. How do you get to do it? Just disclaimer, this next few minutes might be not safe for work.
No.
All right. How do you get a Jewish girl's number?
How?
You roll up her sleeve. How many Jews can you fit in a car? According to the Germans, you can fit about 5 million of them in the ashtray.
Okay, this would be jokes that my brother would love.
All right. So, my friend was walking down an alleyway one day, and he met this beautiful homeless girl. He took her home. They had lunch. They had dinner. They had a shower, and then he took her to bed. And the noise that was coming out of her, you would have thought that she was still alive.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That's a cut joke.
Yeah. Yeah, most of these aren't making it to the Facebook, just saying.
Yeah, that's fair. How many Kiwis, how do you get 10 Kiwis into a car?
Just remember that the artist that is tattooing you today is Kiwi.
Oh, you're going to love this one, then.
Yeah.
How do you get 10 Kiwis into a car?
Is it something to do with sheep?
No, tell them there's fish and chips in there.
It's fish and chops.
How do you get 10 Kiwis out of a car? Tell them they have to pay.
You're making a lot of friends today.
No. So one of my
sort of dark humor was back in the days of school when they were just all like dead baby jokes. Do you remember the one where it was like, what sits in the corner progressively getting shorter?
What?
A baby brushing its hair with a potato peeler.
That's fucked up.
Yep.
Amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Cancel.
Yeah. Cancelled. 18 plus.
You say 18 plus, but like half of them aren't even 18 anymore.
Pretty much, yeah.
One of my one of my co-workers, one of my good friends, his name is Julia. He's in, I think he's 53 now, and I work with him. And he used to be the heavyweight champion of New Zealand when it came to boxing.
Okay.
And he's like, he showed me all these pictures and stuff like this, and I told him that joke, and he just looked at me, and he's like, I have to hate you now.
I'm not allowed to like you anymore.
Yeah.
So getting back onto frogs, what is your favourite type of frog?
It's really hard. Anything from, like, the Hylidae family, so, like, the tree frogs.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, literally, I can, anything from a poison dart frogs to, like, the moss frogs. Like, they're just all so cool.
I did see a video on Facebook, which I'm pretty sure is fake, of a white tree frog. You ever seen one of them?
Yeah.
Yeah, apparently they're, like, this big, and I'm just like, nah, that can't be right.
No, the biggest one's probably the size of your hand. They can get up to, like, 7 centimeters long. I mean, my little tattoo underneath here, all the natural colours a green tree frog can be.
Mm. Yeah, I figured it was some sort of camera trick I saw.
Yeah. But yeah, not one singular
thing. Yeah, other frogs that can get huge.
Yeah, they're the bullfrogs. You know, they're, like, whole, like, they're, like, the size of your head.
Mm.
I love
them. Are they the ones that carry the little babies in their mouth?
So, you know those big ones that, like, people hold, like burgers?
Mm.
Like those massive ones, bullfrogs?
Why are you relating a bullfrog to a burger?
That's how you hold it.
Yeah, they're like this.
They're massive. Yeah. That's so cool. And even, like, I think, I'm not sure if it's, like, America, but other countries, they're, like, really, really big and massive.
Like, are you talking weird. About the Americans
frogs,
or the
frogs? The frogs. Yeah, they're really cool. Right, the ones in Australia are quite small. The biggest is probably the grey tree frog.
Mm.
No,
they're cute, though.
They're cute, yeah. Except you're in the middle of nowhere, and there's like
and
a thousand.
And they pop out of you.
There's like 1,000 in the public toilets when you're at a camping trip.
Mm.
It's so cool.
They're just helping. They're just helping.
Yeah, they're helping the tourists.
They're so cute, though. I love the little tiny ones, too. There's lots of little tiny ones.
I love when they clean their face because they like do that little like cat thing.
Yeah.
Mm.
That's adorable.
Yeah. Oh, when they're swallowing, they blink, and then they move a little bit.
Yeah, I think there was one that I saw where it was like, if like the tadpole's in a pond and the pond is going dry, the father will actually grab all the tadpoles
put them in the mouth.
And then transfer them to another thing. You'll like dig out a little channel.
There's actually a type of frog that gives live birth.
I have heard about that, actually.
Yeah.
It's like sharks. Like, technically sharks have eggs, but they're born inside the shark. Yeah. Yeah.
I think. All I think of sharks, I think baby sharks, think of them cutting open the little eggs to help the sharks come out.
Mm. Yeah, it's weird when you think about what actually lays eggs. Like, Australia is home to the only monotremes in the world, which is the platypus and the echidna. So the only two mammals that actually lay eggs.
Yeah, we're kind of fucked up over here.
Yeah. Well,
they call us the devil's playground.
Yeah, well, when they first discovered the platypus, all of the scientific community thought it was a hoax. Every single person who they showed it to, they thought it was fake. They were just like, oh no, this like thing with a duck's bill, a freaking beaver's tail, an otter's body, it's got claws, it has venom, it lays eggs, it also like produces milk. It's like, this is like all the things that...
Just a random
concoction.
Platypus is also, there's only one male per channel of water. They're very territorial.
I didn't know that one.
And you can find them around here.
They'll fuck you up.
I thought they were only in Tasmania.
No, they're all around Australia. We actually do platypus surveys around here.
Oh, cool.
There's so many of them. But it's really hard to see.
Platypus surveys is what turned me off from being an ecologist to being more of a water science person.
Yeah.
Because I can't sit there at like the crack of dawn for like 6 hours.
And then just wait for something to maybe show up.
A waterway. I'm like, I cannot do this. I'd rather grab the sample and analyze it.
Mm.
Does this water have something that can kill me? Yes.
No. It's Australia, yes.
Most likely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Australia is pretty much just like, if you want to live here, you have to realize that no matter where you go, something wants to kill you, whether it's on the land, in the sky, in the water.
Yeah. Box jellyfish.
Box jellyfish.
They're fucking tiny.
Box jellyfish aren't big. I mean, not small.
Yeah, they are.
Really?
Box jellyfish.
Box jellyfish like this big.
Yeah, I thought so.
Yeah, the blue bottles are this big.
What are the
really small ones. They're like the ones that are like almost invisible.
They'll kill you.
Yeah.
Like within 30 minutes or something like that, aren't they?
Mm.
Just fucking just off.
Not even 30 minutes, it's 2 minutes.
Yeah, I think between getting stung by a box jellyfish and stepping on a freaking like rockfish or a stonefish, I think I just would never go in the water again.
Yeah, I'm not much of a water person. That's not always like
I was going to say, like, you're a water person, you study water, but you don't want to go there.
No, I love the like more
creeks, rivers, indoors, yes, out, anything to do
with. I watch too much like tsunami movies, and I'm always like, if I ever want to live somewhere, I live on a mountain, on top of a mountain, so then if it floods and it's a huge tsunami, I would die.
Smart.
For a very, like, out of all the things that can go wrong on this planet, I think a tsunami is like, it's up there. But we need to get like, we also need to like make sure the fucking mountain is also earthquake proof and shit like
that. Yeah, it's not on a fault line.
Yeah.
All right. Do you want to take a look in the mirror? Make sure you're happy with it? Or are you happy with that?
Yeah. Looks good.
Yeah?
There's a
mirror. Yeah, of course, look in the mirror. Yeah.
Gross. And that leaves plenty of room. There's another one, like a small one here.
Yeah.
And put some extra vines and stuff around for the next session.
Not sure if I can get a little done, but I'll try my best.
I was going to say, what I'll do is I'll do the outline first.
Yeah.
And then if you're not feeling up to it, we can do all the shading and colour next time.
Yeah, I thought so.
And for the ivy things, you wanting a little bit of green?
Yeah, definitely.
Just like little tiny bits.
I feel like almost like a watercolour. Is that what they look like?
Yeah. Cool. Done.
What?
I'm trying to think of something fun.
You don't have to. We can have moments of silence. I can just cut that out.
Oh, I like the moments of silence. They're my favourite.
I'm sure she does too.
Hmm.
She talks more than me, which is the thing that gets me.
I mean, you can talk just as much.
I finish work at like 9:30 at night, get home, and I'm like, oh man, go rid of it. And she's like, can we talk about this?
Oh, and it's like when you're trying to go to sleep, and it's like, oh, what's
this? She's been saving up all the conversation all day.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you talk just as much. That's why I married him.
You married him for the banter?
I thought it was life insurance.
Fair enough.
That was after we got married. You didn't have a job when I first married.
Oh, you was a broke-ass bitch when she
first married. Oh, fuck yeah.
When we first met, and then it kind
of switched. No, when we first met, she was the one with the job, I didn't have a job, and now it's completely switched.
Role reversal.
I'm trying. I have a bachelor's degree. Yeah.
Cool.
My job.
What degrees do you have?
Me? Yeah. I have a diploma in nursing.
Oh, cool. What kind of nursing?
Trauma.
Trauma?
Trauma.
I think it's a trauma.
Trauma. Yeah, trauma. Trauma. Trauma.
That's the Australian way to say trauma.
Yeah, two certifications.
Trauma.
Yeah. But they technically no longer exist. Because Chase Queensland discontinued its medications in history.
Really?
Yeah, which kind of makes me really.
Yeah, it's like, oh, the first thing it said to me when I graduated, it's like, oh, not like I'm proud of you. No, I want to do a degree now.
What? That is such a lie. I said I felt so inspired by watching me graduate that I wanted to go get a history degree. And then I found out there's no such thing as a history
degree. There is an EQ found out that short.
Yeah, I think that's more of an American thing.
Piss me off. Fuck you, America. You want all the history?
You know that in the States, actually, they have a psychology degree which actually studies the psychology of Batman?
That is fucking beautiful.
Yeah, because what the whole thing with Batman is, it's basically just, he's basically one walking trauma cycle. And there's even an entire comic run in Batman.
Like 90% of superheroes is some type of trauma.
Oh, yeah. Like, there was an entire run where Captain America was fighting all of the different drugs, like all the different street drugs, but like the personifications of them. But with Batman, there's actually an entire section of the book of the comic books where he actually isn't fighting anyone. Because after his parents died, he had a psychological break and then was taken to Arkham Asylum for the criminally insane. And all of the villains that he fights, Dr. Joe Kerr is the head doctor of Arkham Asylum, and that's his arch nemesis. His nurse is Dr. Harlene Quinzel, and then all of the other Batman villains are just different members of the
Arkham. Oh shit, I've seen that comic book before.
Yeah.
And then there's just Robin, who's his cousin.
And yet we keep getting told the same goddamn stories of Batman in all the movies. Like, they go back to Bruce's parents died, and that's about it.
Oh.
Yeah, like, I think they've had three villains. They've had the Scarecrow, the Joker, and Bane. And then a couple of other little ones scattered through the old ones. But When you get to the later iterations of Batman, it's fascinating. It's actually really, really cool. Like, I want them to do a live-action version of The Bat Who Laughs. The Bat Who Laughs is probably one of the coolest iterations of Batman I've ever seen. It's basically just like this. Imagine the Joker's smile and a massive spiked helm with the bat ears, and that's Batman. So he basically gets fed Joker venom for days and days and days and days until the point where he actually goes absolutely insane.
Is that where he basically turns into the Joker?
With Batman.
With Batman's, and he just fucks everyone.
Yep.
Yes, I've seen.
They need to do a live action version of that. See, I want to see that Batman movie. Or I want to see the one where, like, there was actually a scene in one of the old Batman comics where they had the new Robin and they didn't know whether or not they want to continue with him. So they actually put a vote to the readers whether or not they wanted him to kill him off. And every, like, there was a massive voting saying, yes, kill this guy off. We don't like him anymore. So Joker just beats the crap out of him with a freaking, like, piece of rebar. It's brutal.
Is that the one where he made an entire time machine, not an entire AI, to see if he could save Robin?
I don't remember.
No, that was another one with his son, Damien.
Damien is Robin.
There's a couple different Robins. Well, yeah, there's Jason Todd, there's a few of them.
When Damien comes along, there was two other Robins before him that have become Nightwing and one of the other guys.
Red Hood. Yeah, because Bruce Wayne's son became Batman Beyond.
Yeah.
All right, you ready?
Ugh.
You want to hold my hand?
No, I'm good.
Well, you keep talking about, like, Batman and stuff like that.
Yeah, just start talking about things that you like. Like, what was your favorite cartoon as a kid?
I don't really watch much.
No? You were drier than a desert.
No, I kind of read a lot as a kid, so.
Okay, favorite book then?
Fantasy?
No, what? Magicians?
No, not like it was an older book.
Did you know that there's...
I didn't like Harry Potter until I was in year 9.
Mm-hmm.
And now I like...
You still don't like Harry Potter.
I do. I hate Harry Potter, but I love the world.
Yeah, so the Wizarding World. So you love things like...
I love Fantastic Beasts.
Yeah. So, did you ever play Hogwarts Legacy?
Yeah, we did.
That thing was released within, like, the first day, and we had to go and buy it.
We pre-ordered it.
What's up?
We pre-ordered it.
Yeah, we pre-ordered it and everything.
What house were you?
Ravenclaw.
Me too. Yeah, I was Ravenclaw. I didn't associate well with Gryffindor, and I'm sadistic, but I'm not sadistic enough to be Slytherin. I don't know, Hufflepuff seemed boring to me.
There's the Hufflepuff over here.
I'm a Hufflepuff.
Hufflepuff and blow his house down.
What's that?
So Hufflepuff and blow.
I got nothing against Hufflepuff, but I just never...
Why do I feel like that is an actual insult in the Wizarding World? That is 100% something that somebody would say to a Hufflepuff wizard.
Probably.
And that sounds like it's something that a Ravenclaw would
come up with. Hufflepuff and blow me.
It sounds like a Slytherin.
Yeah, that's something that's like drop and make up. Draco Malfoy would say. Huff and blow me. Gad Potter.
What is that? Why do I admit, after having those two things like put together, I think of Draco Malfoy trying to rape Potter?
That's probably why he was so mean to him, because he fucked him.
I feel like that is the case.
He was, jealous.
I don't think he was jealous.
No, he was. The whole thing about it.
He wanted to slither into his Gryffindor.
I think the funniest part about it was at the very end of the entire trilogy, Harry Potter literally bought his son a... What was it called? What was the animal that he got?
Ferret.
A ferret, just to freak out Malfoy.
Nah.
Because Malfoy kept on looking at it.
Mm-hmm.
The Cursed Child is just... I don't like it.
I haven't actually read that one.
It's just...
What's that?
It's kind of like a fan-made thing. Because he done it, his son goes back in the past to try to...
Was it actually written by J.K. Rowling?
No, I don't think so.
Then it's not real.
It's not canon.
Yeah, so it's, the guy that... Albus? Albus Severus?
Yeah.
Albus Severus Potter.
Albus Severus.
Worst name ever.
Yeah, so it wasn't just me who heard those names.
Oh, God, it was...
What's wrong with you, you idiot?
It was like, so, yeah, I get it. Snape was looking after you the entire time, but you knew that for all of 30 seconds.
Snape was literally getting out his hatred of his father.
Yeah, he wanted to fuck your mom, Harry. Not a reason to name your kid after.
Jealousy is just the whole fruit.
Yeah, Harry Potter. He did not like you. He liked your mum.
So you're one of those people who like, I still...
Why didn't he name him after Sirius?
Because Sirius was great. Except, yeah. Like, he was only in, like, 2 books.
Yeah, but he was more of a parental figure to Harry than anybody else.
Was Sirius, wasn't it? His first child was...
Was Albus Severus.
And then his second one was Sirius.
Sirius James?
Was it?
Was it? I don't remember.
James Sirius.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that makes sense.
Lily Luna?
Yeah, well, yeah.
But I don't know, just Albus Severus does not roll off the tongue.
Do you know what really got me? What's his name? The one that killed the basilisk snake at the very end.
Ron.
No, not fucking Ron.
Oh no,
that was
Neville. Neville Turner, he's fucking hot today. I don't know his real name, but fuck, he looks good.
It's like the dude, the big dude from My Name is Earl. He got jacked.
Fuck yeah. I look at that type of shit and I'm just like, fuck.
Or Will Poulter. He's had a massive glow up since the freaking with the Robinsons.
Yeah.
Oh no, with the Millers. Yeah. Yeah, since he became Adam Warlock.
He's the one in that was in the Maze Runner as well, wasn't he?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, he progressively went from, like, little wee all the way up to, like, and him growing the beard and everything.
Fuck you up, yeah.
You know who didn't grow up gracefully? The kid who became Bran from Game of Thrones. He started off as, like, the cutest kid.
Oh, the incest kid.
No. The kid who got pushed out of the tower.
Oh, the wheelchair boy.
Yeah, the guy who became the Three-Eyed Raven.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, started off as the cutest kid, then disappeared for a whole season, and I don't know what the hell happened.
And then the very end of the season, I looked at him, and I'm just like...
Is that the same kid?
I hope to God it's not.
I think it is.
As bad as that sounds.
Like, honestly, I'm reading through Game of Thrones again right now, and I'm seeing exactly where the books stopped mattering with the series. Because...
Book one, chapter one.
No. Book one and two? Pretty damn close. Even book three, pretty moderately on par. After season four, it starts to fall off.
Was there actually that much incest in the books?
Oh, yeah. Like, there's a whole thing about Jaime wanting to marry Cersei because everyone already knows about it now.
That's fucked up.
Mm. Hey, it can't be anywhere as bad as what happened in the It book. Holy crap. That movie was weird. The book. Stephen King is amazing, but he's a bit fucked in the head.
You have to be to make it interesting.
You know, he can't even sleep with the lights on. He can sleep without the lights on. One of the greatest horror writers of all time has to sleep with the lights on. But there's an entire scene at the end of the first part when they're kids and they beat Pennywise for the first time. Spoiler alert. You know how in the movie they cut each other's hands to make like a little blood pact sort of thing to say, oh, if this happens again, we'll come back. They don't do that in the book. She has sex with all of them. The young girl has sex with all of the boys in the sewers.
That makes sense.
They're like 12.
Get a fucking pound town.
I'm like, what the hell? That was not necessary.
Duh.
It's like, I know Stephen King's a little, but when I was reading that, I actually had to physically stop tattooing and be like, what the hell did I just hear?
in the middle of tattooing. And she bent down and took them all. Wait, what?
I physically had to stop and just like, what did I just hear?
That poor fucking dude who you were tattooing.
No, I kept my composure. He didn't know.
He was like, what the fuck?
I kind of disguised it as just like, oh, I'm just going to go get my ink. What
the hell did I do for you? Oh, so fucked.
Females who listen to those, what do you call it, serial killer documentaries?
Oh, my wife loves those.
I don't know.
What's that?
Serial killer documentaries. Or the true crime, or the unsolved mysteries. Like, The wife's favorite thing is like Criminal Minds, NCIS, Special Victim Unit. The amount of times I've heard that, dum, dum. Continue.
What are you talking about?
I don't know.
I remember gangbang.
What?
I remember 12-year-old gangbang. I remember that part.
Yeah, that's Stephen King being a freaking freak.
That'll never leave my head now.
You're welcome. If I have to know that, you have to know that. Oh, we're talking about crime shows.
Oh, yes. We were talking about the dun-dun part. I remember
what,
that.
What's the meme? Tell me about the meme.
Oh, there's like hundreds of memes. And it's like, you'll see a short video of like somebody doing something sketch, and then it'll be like, dun-dun, special crime investigation unit. Like, he's about to get it fucking right. It's so bad. But that would probably be like my dream job, to work in this, in like a...
Didn't you say you wanted to work in like sexual crime?
Yeah, I'd love to work in that type of place.
I want to work, not with...
I would love to work with sexual...
See, clients. I'm glad I get to work with people, but they pay me to staff them, so it's fun.
That's pretty fair.
Hmm. It's cathartic, but also therapeutic. I have that many people who actually like almost fall asleep in the chair because they're just like,
it's nice. I just dropped myself.
How do you feel? You
distract yourself with randomness.
Yeah, keep talking.
Talk more.
No, that's good. You're much more better than the, what?
We think Cat in the Hat.
Everyone thinks Cat in the Hat. Who hasn't seen Cat in the Hat?
I'm sad that I saw the live action one.
What? There was a...
Yep. Guy who played Shrek played the Cat in the Hat.
Mike Myers.
Mike Myers played Cat in the Hat. It was like seeing Johnny Depp as Willy Wonka. It was weird. As much as I love Johnny Depp and as long as I love Mike Myers, there are some roles they should never have played.
Yeah.
And it's... Whew, it's rough.
What are your thoughts on Johnny Depp? Have you watched Fantastic Beasts?
I have, yes.
What do you think of Mads Mikkelsen?
I love Mads Mikkelsen. Mads Mikkelsen is his name.
Mikkelsen.
Wow.
Mads Mikkelsen is his name, yeah. Also played Hannibal Lecter.
And he was in Doctor Strange too.
Yes. It's like, Mr. Doctor. If that's strange, actually. Maybe, but who am I to say?
Actually, it's not bad. Like, it's kind of like what they did with Harry Potter and Dumbledore. Like, the first two movies had the guy. But then he died.
I was going to say, then he died, so they didn't really have much of a choice.
I would like Johnny Depp to come back, though. He played him really well. Mads Mikkelsen just looks really old.
Well, he is old.
Because Stupid was so much younger than Mads Mikkelsen. It kind of like looks like weird. And how they did like the love thing, the games.
Well, we always knew that Dumbledore was a little bit... And yeah, it was a bit of a weird twist, but honestly, that movie was just boring.
They never openly
like
said that
it was. Good.
It was really sad when he killed that little deer thing.
Yeah, that kind of stuffed me up for a while.
I don't know, like, I think when it comes to, like, Harry Potter movies and superhero movies, there comes a point where there's nothing really you can do that's not going to feel contrived.
And then with like Queenie in the second movie going through the blue flame, and then the third movie she like went against it, and it's like blue flame's like eternal.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if she was in that mindset at that point in time, but that was only because she wanted to marry Jacob. But that was like, why would she even go evil?
RJ with the Muggles!
A war.
What did I say?
A war with Muggles begins today.
The no matches, the can spells.
Oh, we call them Muggles.
That's racist.
You know, what's up, my Muggle?
I'm not a Muggy, you Muggle.
I'm a mud blood.
Which is really funny because the entire, I like how the purists were all like, they cannot be as good at us, and I'm like, Voldemort is my blood.
Mm-hmm.
Not really. He's a half-blood.
That's what a mud blood is.
A mud blood is a person with no matched parents.
Is it?
Yes.
I thought it was anyone who
Hermione
had...
Hermione is a mudblood because she has no...
Yeah, both of her magical... Both
she's
her
no magical parents.
I thought it was like half-blood and under.
So
no. Like, I thought it was like if they
what
had...
What is
dirty
blood?
Yeah, so like if they had like tainted blood.
Okay, let's put this to bed.
But as Hagrid says, there's not a wizard alive today who's not half-blood or less.
Dirty blood sees common blood. Explain all the mudblood. Was a highly derogatory term for either a muggle or a muggle born or half born wizard or half witch.
Yeah, so it has any tainted blood in it because pure bloods are magic. Hmm. So it's like they're hated by both.
Well, then technically pure blood is like no magic.
Yeah, exactly. So like all the Malfoys and such have had like pure blood lineage for years and years. That's why they hate any muggles. Like you'd never see a Malfoy marry a muggle. It would never happen.
Maybe you didn't like it, Mark.
Actually, you know Draco Malfoy's wife. What's her name?
You want me to Google that one?
Her wife is actually a maledictus, like.
So he's able to transform.
Yeah, like the genie, the blood. You know, I actually made a book, like on Wattpad. I used to write stuff on Wattpad, which is like you write books, like people write a lot of fandom stuff on it. I wrote a book about how Voldemort had a sister, and that was Nagini. And that was back in like 2015. Oh, yeah. And then they had the movie come out with the genie being a maledictus, and I'm like, ah, they stole that idea off me. I swear by that.
People were trying to say that the first snake in the first movie was Nagini. I'm just like,
No.
Definitely not.
It was a boa constrictor.
Yeah.
She's kind of...
She's getting passionate. She doesn't like Harry Potter.
Ironically, the kid that was like, oh, read Harry Potter. I love all this stuff. And then I was like, no, never. And then Year 9 was like, from then on.
You know what my favorite book series as a kid? Animorphs. Well, they're basically maledictuses.
They had a Disney thing of the movie, not a series of them.
Mm.
I used to read like a lot of like fairy books, or like those, you know, like wizardology books with like you open like the little things. I used to
love. Well, I have one of those with the dragons, like the what was it, like the Opus of Dragons or whatever it was called.
Yeah.
I think the thing I was most obsessed with when I was really young was dinosaurs.
Yes. I think every kid was.
Mm-hmm.
I was obsessed with dinosaurs.
I wanted to be a paleontologist for my first job.
Well, you wanted to be an author, I think.
An author.
Write books.
I don't think I could ever be a soldier. Like, if I was ever going to be any part of the military, I think I'd be a sniper.
That's a soldier.
If I was going to be anything, it would be a soldier. It would be a sniper. I wouldn't want to be like a foot soldier. I wouldn't.
The military or a soldier first.
Yeah, I know.
The problem is if you wanted to be a part of the sniper corps, you'd have to join a corps, then go for selections.
And dresses.
And through, you can do it really well. And then afterwards, you got to do like fucking courses on end to show that you're fucking able to do it.
Mm, you have to learn the Coriolis effect and the way that the earth turns, and then wind speed, and then rotation of the bullet, and then muzzle velocity. Yeah.
Actually, when you shit yourself
there.
It's shot out of the weapon. Mm. And it's spinning like a football. It's called rifling.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Coriolis effect is the curvature of the earth.
Yeah.
So when you fire, it depends on how fast it's rotating. Yeah.
And I think of that. I think of that one video of a flat earther, and then he's doing like a little test flight. And the earth is flat.
Yeah, I've seen that before. Where he's a fully adventing flat earth and saying, oh, the earth is completely flat. You can't tell me wrong. And then three videos later, being like, I have never been so wrong before in my life.
And he's like, Shani's like, are you sure you're straight? Yes. Let's stop.
All those.
Just put it above your head. Mm. Ah, interesting.
Or someone puts like a level on the ground and be like, aha, the earth is flat. See the bubble?
Oh my God.
Mm. Yeah. See, I find it hilarious. Well, not hilarious. I find it inspiring. People are so fervent in their beliefs that even if it is completely insane, they'll be like, no, I will believe this until I die.
I'm pretty sure the Nuremberg trial showed us that.
Mm-hmm.
It was when all the Nazi working victim of doing naughty things.
Is that part of the Geneva Convention?
Nah, that was formed just after World War One, and it was basically to not harm humans in really, really bad ways.
Oh, that is like the worst spot.
No, that's the worst spot.
Okay, so I love Warhammer 40K. It's fucking awesome.
Yeah, you made like a 3-hour video on it.
I love that Henry Cavill's getting creative freedom to start the cinematic universe.
You have no idea on how much that makes me happy.
Oh,
I know, right?
It makes me happy. That motherfucker is so
he deserves,
in touch.
He deserves it. He deserves all of the creative freedom.
He is the nerd king, let's just be honest. Not even the nerd king, he's just...
He is the nerd god, just saying.
I think one of my favourite ones is I read a book on Astartes and they ran into... I forgot those aliens were called.
In what?
Oh, the fuck. There's so fucking many of them. But anyway, it was a battle and they were like, you killed hundreds of thousands, if not millions and billions of your own people. For what? And the Astartes turns around and goes, practice. I'm like,
oh. Sorry? Please don't hit the table.
Sorry, that was my fault.
Yes, it was. So
sorry. Are you okay?
Luckily, I wasn't moving too far there.
That was probably my favourite book. My favourite part of the...
I've been meaning to get into reading all of the Warhammer 40k stuff, but there are so many.
There is no finish, there is no start, there is just eternity.
It's like I wanted to start reading the Star Wars ones as well, but I looked at how many there were and was like, oh my god.
I would suggest starting with the Death Corps of Krieg, and then going on to the Battle of Rocks after that, and then just starting there, because they have a really good history, and it's really well documented.
Did you watch Acolyte?
Wait, there's Star Wars.
Do
you not watch that?
I've heard nothing but bad.
No, the lightsaber turned red within 30 seconds because she felt bad. Does that mean that Anakin Skywalker slaughtered all those younglings and other Jedi with fucking glee, my boy?
There was that thing about him turning, like, his eyes turning color, but that apparently does happen when they, like, the dark side takes over. But it doesn't affect the Kyber Crystal. The Kyber Crystal has to go through an entire separate process.
There was literally a comic book, and it took Dark, like, literally after the Mustafar thing and after he turned into Darth Vader, there was a full comic book about how Palpatine literally told him to go change his Kyber Crystal. He had to go to an ancient fucking Sith world, and he had to forcibly make that motherfucker red.
Yeah, like, it was all your malice comic. Network, yeah.
Yeah, it was like a full...
See, I haven't even read that comic, and I knew that. And there was a thing about, like, the witches or whatever, like, using midichlorians to impregnate people or something to create new... Yeah, I've not seen Acolyte. I've heard things. I do not know how many of them are true, but most of them make me not want to read it.
They turn around and they're like, this stuff is canon. And I'm like, how is that fucking canon? That just fucks up the entire movies.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you realize...
I'm sorry, episode 8 fucked up the movies.
Yeah.
With the freaking fuel and, like, the slightly smaller and smaller and faster than us, so we can only keep it a certain distance and keep blasting them, yada yada. That entire movie just... Ugh.
I have a great idea. I'm going to turn around and go into hyperspace and then smash the entire fleet. Do you know that could have...
That was amazing.
That was
when Holdo did that. That was the entire movie. That was the only reason I remember anything from that movie.
That was an awesome scene, but the thing that fucked
that
me
sound,
up.
About that
sound. The only thing that pissed me off about it was why, if this was happening during the Civil War of the Galaxy, why didn't they just make a whole bunch of suicide fucking?
Yeah, they can make drone-piloted fleets and do that.
Fuck them up.
Yeah, like, imagine making, like, a warp-speed missile.
Yeah.
You only just watched Star Wars once.
And the thing that gets sad about me is, like, it was never done again.
Yeah.
It's never been ever done.
They talked about it at number 9, where he's like, we need to start pulling some holdo maneuvers. And that was...
That was that.
That was Mary Brandybuck said that. The guy who played Mary in Lord of the Rings said, we need to start pulling some holdo maneuvers. I'm just like... Okay, that could work, yes. Mass suicide, but...
That is Nibi.
Yeah, they could literally, like, get R2 to hack all the freaking planes and then have R2 pilot them all or something. I mean, he's able to do
everything... We did that before in the Clone Wars.
Yeah, he's able to do everything else with that little freaking, like, robo dick of his.
Have you heard of that thing where it's like R2 could have just told Luke the whole time?
Oh, yeah. He could have, but he just...
Yeah, R2 was, like, the biggest MacGuffin in movie history.
Which is really funny because technically everything's being told by his perspective.
Mm.
Which is a theory, not actual canon.
It's just a theory.
A film. Well, there we go.
Nah, I'll bleep that out.
Oh my god. I can't believe that would actually be a strike just saying something that stupid. The other thing that I'd love to do if I could, it would probably be going to space.
Yes and no.
I wouldn't.
See, like, okay. Would you rather go down into the Marianas Trench or would you rather go into space?
No.
Like, if you had a, like, James Cameron sub, like, the most advanced freaking thing on the planet to go down and look at all the different, like, essentially alien space creatures.
Yeah, aliens.
Have you heard, they did a thing on the Mariana Trench. Do you know what they found on the bottom?
Sand.
Plastic bag.
Yeah. You know that shit takes, like, 800-900 years to dissolve?
You know, like, most of our body is blood and microplastics.
Yep. They actually found in a few samples of semen.
They're doing studies about that to see if it's going to affect the reproductive system.
It's impossible. I'm the right behind it now. So
I'm so sorry.
I am
Majesty. Jesus Christ.
I'm actually
I'm just people are not like you can make effort, but we've kind of messed up the world to the point where it's like
we're
5 years, but it's inevitable.
We could fix it, but it means that we'll be pouring literally billions of dollars into carbon scrubbers. We'll be sending out massive fleets.
Counter argument to that. Do you know how much the US military spends on budget every single year?
Yeah.
Upwards of
$600 billion.
Up to $1 trillion dollars that I've heard. Imagine taking 10% of that. Yeah. 10% of the trillion, so $100 billion, putting it into anything else. Like every year, change it up. So like 1 year put it into housing for the homeless, 1 year put it into education, 1 year put it into healthcare, 1 year put it into cleaning up the oceans, desalinization plants. They would still have the largest military in the world by a factor of almost 10.
Oh, yeah.
But imagine what $100 billion a year US could do for the world.
I'd love to see it being placed in NASA.
Well, Elon Musk is kind of doing his whole thing with that, too.
Let's be honest. Elon Musk has overtaken every space agency on this planet.
Mm.
Like, legit, he has contracts to every single one of them, and he just fucks them all up. Because they're all like, we've developed something new. And he goes, we did that, like, 10 months ago. We were not going to give it to you. It's actually really funny. I think the funniest thing is when, like, Elon Musk is talking to other space agencies and, like, he shows you all the emails and stuff like that, and he's like, we'll give it to you, but you need to pay us for it. And I'm like, that's pretty fair. You designed something, you made something better.
Mm.
Tell the government, who's not even putting their own money into shit like that, fuck you, they've got to pay for that. They don't get it fucking freely just because they're a space agency.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't put designing his own space agency, that was such a dumb thing to do, and then he's turned it into a private enterprise, which is fucking awesome.
Mm.
Which is...
I am looking forward to the day where they announce that they're going to go terraform Mars.
Oh, man, I can't.
Because then basically we have become space parasites.
Oh, yeah.
We're literally using up all the natural resources of one place, and then we're just going to go migrate to another.
Independence Day.
Extract all the natural resources.
And then do it again.
Keep going.
Independence Day.
Look at the new thing at the moment. Even though you go on Netflix, there's so many, like, what do you call it, post-apocalyptic?
Oh, yeah. Well, it's a hot topic because there's so many different variations. You got, like, nuclear fallout. You got, like, them creating a super virus, which turns people into zombies. You got ones where...
Zombie virus is actually realistic, but it can happen.
Yeah, that's actually really close to...
Oh, yeah.
It's way too close to home, which got me into nursing.
Mm.
Zombie virus. Got me into nursing.
Well, yeah, I was actually going into microbiology.
Oh, I hate microbiology.
But when I did nursing and then I specialised in the labs, I found out that every single person who does medical science is 100% like a dark evil professor.
Oh, yeah.
Because we had to sign waivers of we will not do this. And it is, if you had a really good lab set up, you could do cats really easy, which is literally manipulating DNA.
Mm-hmm.
We did it to... We've done it to...
So basically Jurassic World, but real.
Tokyo, fuck yeah.
Tokyo trials. Like, they did personage like human experiments.
Oh, yeah.
So much human experience.
But from 100 years ago to today, we could literally make a perfect baby. We could.
Oh, well, we've already perfected cloning technology on, like, sheep and stuff, so it's only so long until we start cloning actual humans, and then we got the freaking clone wars on our hands.
That would be awesome.
See, I would like to clone myself if I could, like, have, say, one of me here, or one of me over there, and then one at home doing all the freaking errands. But the problem is, I don't know whether I would annoy myself or not. I think I would. I would think I would piss myself if I piss myself off if I had an exact clone of me.
What's that fucking show called? Invincible. Have you seen it? Where?
Oh, is that the animation?
Where the guy clones himself, but to clone yourself correctly, both of the people think that they're the real one.
Is it like the episode of Simpsons?
Or Multiplicity.
Yeah, where they both believe that they're the real ones, and then they just live and fight with each other.
Or as Rick and Morty would say, decoys.
Yeah.
Decoys, 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 decoys.
How do you know you feel the real one? Well, they wouldn't be very good decoys.
Mm-hmm. Say decoys again. I love that show.
I loved all of it until we started getting up to the later episodes, and it kind of pissed me off that they were taking jokes about their own series, and they just kept on.
They got very meta.
They got bored.
Yeah,
they
like, know lads.
And, like, I know Josh Rowland fucked up, and that's why they had to get rid of him. And the new guy who...
What did he
do? I don't remember exactly, but he was not good. So they actually had to get to the point where they had to change him out with another voice actor. And he does a pretty good job, don't get me wrong, but there are just some words that you can hear, it's like, it's definitely not him. And he's the guy who also voiced Morty, so they're both different.
Yeah.
I don't know, I just haven't found the last season or so very entertaining. Like, I mean, you can't really peek up to Pickle Rick.
I liked watching Morty literally become an absolute...
Tyrant
when it came to women.
Oh, yeah.
Anytime...
That whole thing where he, like, had the, was it the do-over button?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
The one with the crystal?
I think the best one I got me was Planet Peanut, where he just became...
he basically became, like, evil Captain Planet, just got all the freaking... all the rings.
Like, my
just literally bit the dude's finger off and went, fire!
Ha, ha, ha. I liked how from, like, season one he was such innocence, and now he's literally turned into evil Morty.
You hang out with Rick for a week and see what happens to you.
He is literally becoming evil Morty. He will be evil Morty within one.
That's probably going to be the turnaround, is that all the shit that's happened is he's going to become the guy who was looking for the central finite curve.
That would be fucking perfect. I loved Evil Morty.
Ugh, it's a horrible swap.
That's why we're stopping there today when it comes to the height of the tattoo.
Oh, thank God.
That's as high up as we go.
Yay.
And now we go back down.
Are you going to get any higher or is it just stopping?
Yeah.
Well, we're stopping there for today, but it's going to sort of wrap around all the
others. I feel up here. Like,
honestly, when I got mine done, I was almost falling asleep. Like, it really just depends on how your pain threshold is. Like, if this is feeling sore to you, like, what I would consider this part of the arm is probably one of the top five easiest spots to get tattooed. Up here would be in the top five as well. So... like, the front meaty bits of the arm, pretty easy. So we might have to do smaller sessions for those.
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, ew. Nah, it's all right. It'll be okay.
Mm.
We'll do it with the arm.
Mm. Yeah, don't ever feel like you need to push yourself too far.
Yeah. See, spots like that aren't bad.
Yeah. Like, pretty much the entirety of the outline as such is done. All it is now is just filling in shading and
finger combines.
Yeah, I'm just going to go through and do all the patterns and whatnot. So I just got to go through the little veins and the leaves, and then we can start doing some shading.
I just had a horrible hiccup.
You don't even hear.
Hmm?
I didn't hear.
Hey, look at that. Our afterpay went up. We now have $400 that we can use on afterpay. We had 300 before, it's gone up by 100.
Have you been a good boy in paying off of all of your debts?
Yeah. For quite a while. Actually, that's kind of cool.
If you don't want to get an actual coffee, there is iced coffee at Subway.
No. Actually, I don't really like iced coffee. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm getting tattooed, Seth.
I couldn't tell. What do you think gave it away? Is it the needle that's going into your arm?
I'm being penetrated several thousand times a minute here.
Yeah.
All right. Some people find it tedious. Some people find it relaxing. Some people are just like, why am I doing this to myself again? And they look at the tattoo after and it's like, oh, that's why.
Yeah, that's me.
It's fucking cool.
It's cool. And because the frogs.
It's fucking cool.
Frogs.
Have you seen that meme where it's like a witch turns a prince into a frog?
A girl. Frog sits happy on the leaf pad.
Yeah. And it's just like it has never felt so much freedom in its life.
Frog is happy.
Yeah.
There are so many downsides to being a frog, though.
Oh, yeah. Be out of the water for too long.
Be eaten by the French.
Oh. Fuck. Okay. Jeez, just come out of nowhere. Fucking racist, that is. You think all French people eat frogs?
Mm-hmm. Do all French people
eat frogs? Hey, I've seen Americans eat frogs. I've seen the freaking Good Mythical Morning show.
No.
Thinking of a frog on your arm, they're constantly reminded of eating frog like people.
Hey, people get tattoos of cows, but still get burgers.
Yeah, look at the Indian.
The cows.
They find cows sacred.
I don't know, I was trying to be as much ass.
Well, it didn't work. You just look like an ass.
I met an Indian that was only an Indian on like a weekday.
So a hypocrite.
Yeah, because he went up and he got fucking Maccas one day and I'm like, oh fuck.
The cow is not sacred here, so it's okay.
Yeah, I was like, are you allowed to eat that? And he like...
We're not in India.
He looked at me like stunned first and goes, yeah, it's a Saturday. And I'm like, what do you fucking mean? Cows don't get born on Saturdays or some shit? That was pretty funny.
He probably doesn't follow the Bhagavad Gita to the word.
It's more of a guideline.
It's a recommendation.
It's a custom, not a rule.
Because you're not going high anymore.
Jeez, I'm not going higher. I was at the same height. There's a difference.
That was a joke. That'd be funny.
Haha, funny.
It didn't sound like a joke, it sounded like a threat.
At least you weren't going higher, asshole.
Like, I'm not.
I swear.
And then he goes back to low again.
Yeah. Do you want the tattoo done or not? He's not insulting the tattoo artist.
He's just questioning vociferously.
We're not allowed to come back here if you're mean.
I don't know, it's probably a boy.
What's up?
Probably a boy.
That's not an invitation. So the outline's done. Just going to go through and do some shading now. And then if you're feeling up to it, we can do some color.
Oh, the feeling.
That's the best part.
Oh, it smells.
I love the smell.
The smell is amazing. It's the best part.
That's you're lucky. If I can find that smell in a candle,
I've had people ask me to make it into a candle.
Can you make it into a candle?
My sister was looking into it, but the chemical compound that's in the green soap, they can't make into a candle scent. Well, not gonna... Yeah, just a little bit.
Where are you going?
I heard strange noises, but I went to investigate.
He was trying to be protective.
Protective? Fuck no.
I didn't say it her. Said it yourself. Yeah. He was using his biological instinct to be like, I hear strange noises. Must investigate so I don't get eaten.
Do you not want to see
your movies in like just
hidden in there. Well, that's kind of what the leaves are gonna look like anyway. They're gonna have black shading and they're gonna have green tips.
Do you know what absolutely pisses me off in horror movies? That people do not use their big brain and use a fucking stick. They go off and they start, what are you doing, my man? What are you doing? Get a fucking stick. You have big brain, use stick. And then you just see him go off the pipe and I'm like, fucking stick, pole, pipe, anything. Fucking.
Longer than finger.
Exactly.
If I saw a dead body, or if I even saw a body on the ground, do you know what I do? I kick their legs or their feet.
Why anyone, when they're like running away from something or like something's coming after them, they don't pick up the nearest object?
I'd be flinging that at those motherfuckers.
Mm.
Be like, chairs, coffee, mate, fuck anything.
Kick them in the shins, kick them in the nuts, anything.
Anything, I'll be fucking.
Is there any like water in here?
Oh, you need to go to the bathroom?
Yeah, quickly.
Okay. Right, I'll wrap this up.
Probably not
done. Yeah. You're about to go to the, like, festive area.
Yeah, I wasn't going to let you go down there unwrapped.
Yeah. Not help you.
Now, Hedness!
I am playing glass
now. There we go. Now it's working.
Then you go on the smoking barrel. He's in him with wife in his door, doing some stuff to him. Yeah, such a stuff in
It's like, look at the memes. Look at the memes.
There's just so much meme to send to you, but it's can't send them to you. Horrible.
Are you lying out here?
The feeling is just... It just stops your heart for a second, you know?
Feel the pain. Love the pain.
Embrace the pain.
What it is.
Pain is your friend.
Do you think I should become a tattoo artist?
No.
Why not? I think it might be fun. Not fun, but I think it'd be
cool. You got a writing?
Yeah, yes. You've seen my drawings, they're pretty good. I think I might have to go get an arts degree for that, though.
You have an arts degree in history, huh?
I'm gonna throw something at you.
I would never get an arts degree in history.
I don't have an arts degree.
Courses and arts degree are like criminology and history.
Which makes no fucking sense.
I'm like, why do you call it arts then? There's nothing to do with arts.
Like apparently murdering people is an art form.
Yeah, some criminals would say yeah to that one.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here's my handle, here's my belt. Why are you looking at me like
you
that?
Said spout twice.
What's up?
You were supposed to say I'm a little teapot, short and stout. You said spout.
Oh, I like spouting off the word. Nah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that was bad.
Yeah, a lot of this is being cut.
And you think I talk more than him?
No.
I'm trying to give you something to distract.
Mm-hmm.
See how it is. You know, fine, you know, I'm quiet over here now.
I'm going to go look at my memes. And I'm not even going to show them to you. I'll just sit there laughing. I'm not even going to tell you what it is.
No, you're looking at me. You're probably on my face. No, it's not Instagram. Fucking, what do you call it? YouTube.
Something that you're not banned from.
Banned from YouTube.
No, it's not hard to get banned from YouTube. Hell, half the shit that we've said today we could get banned on YouTube.
Challenge accepted.
No, thanks. I don't want to have my YouTube channel banned.
Okay.
Now, if you put this all on Patreon, then that's fine.
Patreon is basically OnlyFans.
Pretty much. It's like, here, pay money to hear us say things that you can't say normally.
Would you like to see something? Make sure you give me $10 on Patreon for a month. Boom.
What's your, like, most popular tattoo?
Ooh. I'd say probably the most requested thing I've been getting recently is like animal portraits, so like tigers, wolves, things like that. Lions became a huge thing for a long time. I do a lot of flowers, I do a lot of fine line stuff. I don't really have a specific most requested thing. The way that I kind of act as an artist is like I don't really have a set style. I pretty much just cater whatever I'm doing to what my client asks for. I think the only thing I don't really want to do yet anyway is family portraits.
Mm.
See, I think they need to be done by someone who specializes in that sort of style because it is so emotionally charged. Oh, I've done people. Like I've done like a generic like female Chicano things. I've done ones of like just generic faces. Mm. Like I can do celebrity portraits because they generally have very good recognition.
Yeah.
And they have really high quality photos to work with. A lot of the times when you have, like, say someone wants to bring in like a picture of their grandmother or their baby or something, it's generally not the best quality. And it takes a very specific eye to be able to see the details beyond what you can see in a photo.
Mm.
And I think with family portraits, it needs to be something where you need to capture that person's soul. It's not a matter of just making it look kind of like the person. So I would leave that sort of emotionally charged one to someone who knows exactly how to get it 100% perfect every time.
I want this place. Well, if you don't want my face on your arm?
See how look at your face every day.
I have a really weird question.
Okay.
Has right. anybody got any of the tattoo their dick or around that area?
I've tattooed around that area. I once had a request for a for me to do a dick tattoo for a music video. It never happened, thankfully. I have done piercings in that area, though. Yeah, I've done piercings pretty much everywhere. I've tattooed above the mound, as we shall call it. Yeah, it's something I've done before. I personally don't want to hold a guy's dick in my hand for longer than I have to.
Make it hard.
Yeah. That'd be a very awkward conversation, wouldn't it? But yeah, I've had requests for it. I haven't done any as of yet, because it's just not something I want to do. Yeah, I've had.
Can I get pierced? That's the question. Where would you allow me to be pierced?
Just put a bar through his lip 3 or 4 times so he can't open his mouth.
You got like where you got those emo ones?
No. Somewhere where it wouldn't be seen, like on the tongue.
Just no. That's no.
If you're going to get a piercing, it's to be shown, pretty much. Whether to everybody or to certain people.
You get single.
No, that's gay.
Well, piercing in men is gay.
What?
Well, piercing in men is just emo. Are you emo or are you gay?
That's a very generic sort of thing to say.
I see how it is.
Like, a regular guy won't just have an eyebrow piercing.
Oh, yeah, that's a bit weird. You know what? I had a guy who works with me all the time, Jeremy, who was like, he was on fucking speed or cocaine like 90% of the time that I worked with him. Fucking guaranteed. Guaranteed. One day I was working with him and he pulled out this medical bag and he opened it. Up. And he's like, have you seen that scene in the movie where the dude's like, what do you want? I got everything. I got oxycarcin, fentanyl. And like, that was like legit that in real life. And he's like, I got everything you need. What do you need? Do you need something for your headache? Do you need something to help you wake you up today? And I'm like, is this legal? And he goes, yeah, it's legal.
Somewhere.
I'm like,
at least you don't see me.
Anyway, one day I was working with him and he was definitely on fucking cocaine or something because he was talking 1,000 miles per hour. And, He turned back up after 30 minutes. I'm like, where'd you go? And he goes, look, I got my fucking ears pierced. Back in the day, this used to be fucking gay, but I think it looks good now.
It apparently, I think it was used to be the right ear was considered gay because I think it was Elton John or someone had that pierced in one ear. So people just assumed that made you gay. I don't know where else the rumor would have come from. But yeah, it's the whole piercing makes you gay thing. That was quite silly back in the day.
20 bucks is 20 bucks.
20 bucks to get the piercing?
Imagine walking up to somebody with like a tag on their ear and be like, excuse me, sir, does this mean you offer some
medicine? But I just think of like the vegans and of like the animal tag. Oh. You're not mean to offend vegans. Vegans are great. It's a lifestyle.
Vegan? They're fucking retarded. Every single vegan I've run into, they're always like, I do this because I care about animals, and I'm like, then you might as well just not eat food and die.
Haven't you seen how animals are treated? They're like gods.
No, that's not what I mean, but a lot of them are like, oh, we shouldn't be eating, we should only eat that. And I'm like, how big and how adorable does the animal have to be until you fucking care? Because to plant soy trees, to plant vegetables, to plant all of that type of stuff, the soil has to be tilled. Which is basically when they get a big ass fucking tractor.
They kill more animals by killing, like by harvesting soybeans than they do.
Yeah, it's like those, what are the oil palms, whatever they're called, that they use when they cut down trees. Animals can't eat them. They can't live in them. They're literally just.
They avoid nutrients into the soil. It's what destroyed half of Borneo.
Borneo is still trying to fix that up.
Oh, and have you seen that they've actually found that plants can actually feel things now?
Oh, yeah.
So what are vegans going to do now? Eat air? Yeah, because they show that trees and plants and stuff can communicate with each other, so they have a form of sentience, form of intelligence.
When one tree gets chopped down, they all give it nutrients to grow back.
Actually, the smell that you can smell when grass is being cut is a defense mechanism.
The smell that we actually... Mmm, I love the smell of
fruit. Yeah, that's a defense mechanism from grass. Oops. Apparently, it's a deterrent or something, but it's like...
Yeah, it is a deterrent.
Mm.
But they don't have pain receptors, so it's okay. Yeah, they got it.
Unless you know that they're
not. Yeah.
It's like, how do you know? Have you asked a blade of grass what it feels like?
Wait. Doesn't that mean that it's more... What's the word? It's more... Not humanitarian. What?
Inhumane?
Yeah, it's more inhumane to eat vegetables than it is to eat meat, because at least with meat, it's one shot kill.
The good thing about Australia is that most of the vegetables they have, like, what do you call it, cover crop, or they're like cabbage, and that brings nutrients back in soil. And
No. What I mean, like, if I eat a cabbage, I'm hurting the cabbage.
Cabbage is
like, and like every single bite is going to hurt the cabbage.
Well, once the cabbage has been de-rooted, like it's cut off from the base, it's basically dead.
Oh, okay.
You're just eating its corpse.
You're basically just eating the decaying body of something that was once alive.
Yeah, I don't mind that. That's all right.
So once it's already dead, it's fine.
So vegans are basically going to eat anything.
Mm.
Yeah, pretty much.
There was a restaurant in New South Wales that banned vegans from coming in.
I did say that as either, like, if you're a vegan or a food critic, do not come in.
Yeah.
I remember seeing a billboard going towards, I think it was Coomera Way. I can't remember the name of the hotel. It was the worst vegetarian restaurant in Queensland or something. It was for a steakhouse.
Yeah.
Oh, didn't...
Like the Bates Hotel or whatever it was called.
I remember there was a massive controversy because, what's that British Scottish chef's name? Gordon Ramsay banned vegans from coming into his store.
I didn't know that.
He turned around and he banned him because there was a big controversy at one of his stores where a vegan got mad because they were processing meat there. And also, his signature dish is a Wellington.
Yeah, and he has the Ramsay burger. It's like, why would you go into a place that is renowned for its meat dishes and complain that they're cooking meat? Like, if they were cooking meat in the same pan as your vegetarian vegan dish or whatever, sure, I'd be a little bit upset. But the fact that it's in the same restaurant, what next? It's like, you can't have meat in this state, in this county, in this freaking entire building? Like, I respect anybody's choice to avoid eating meat. Like, humans don't need to eat meat. It's a thing called carnism. Carnism is basically a mentality that has been brought up through humanity where we believe we need to eat meat because it was a ready source of food and protein and whatever. What? There are other forms of protein, but meat is fucking delicious.
Meat wasn't needed at all during our entire evolutionary
stage. There was an entire stage of humanity when we could not afford meat.
Hunters, gatherers.
Yeah.
Which is why the entire agricultural boom happened.
That was the famine for Ireland.
Although we weren't...
The 1920s was the depression.
The humans were never vegan, so to say. There was still, if we could catch it, we would eat it.
Like, there was that whole thing with, like, whole carnivores have specific sets of teeth designed for ripping apart meat or whatever. We don't have those specific teeth. Yeah, we have omnivore teeth. So we can eat both, but we don't have to. In saying that, though, I would probably rather die than go vegan.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Like, I love my meat. I'm a bit of a meat snob, actually.
Well, actually, our body has now transformed into it, and if we don't have meat, we have deficiencies.
Oh, yeah.
Such
like
as iron.
Yeah, you have to take supplements and all this other sort of crap.
Most females are vegan, and they're, like, the most depleted of iron.
You, man, when I worked in the hospitals and I would have people come in and, like, I had a lot of people who would come in and say, oh, I need this, I need this. And I'm like, you guys need to either have a dietary plan where we would get a dietary person come down and they'll be like, you need to eat this amount of chicken, you need to eat this amount. And they're like, oh, no, we don't want to eat. And she's like, okay, you're going to have this, this, and this. And they're like, what is it? And they're like, you don't want to know how iron tablets are made.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because
It is. It's like people who are vegan but still eat like gummy bears and stuff.
Yeah.
Do you know what gelatin is?
Yeah.
It's literally skin, bones, and sinew. Mm. It's like gummies and lollies and stuff aren't fucking vegan.
You can't get away from it because your body needs it. Look, maybe a couple hundred thousand years
ago. Like every time you touch a book, it's not vegan. Okay. If it's a leather bound. Like, you can't get away from it. Humans have used animals in the creation of fucking everything for years. They get boned, hide, meat, fat. Hell, fucking perfume used to be made out of ambergris, the freaking like stomach lining of a whale.
It's actually kind of good to know that humans have used everything.
That's more respectful to me.
Yeah, 100%. Using every single part of it.
Vanilla's from a beaver, isn't it?
Yeah.
The original vanilla.
Yeah, the original vanilla.
Was like from a gland from a beaver, yeah.
Yeah.
And then they found the vanilla bean. Mm. But yeah, I find it more respectful when, like, say, the Native Americans, when they were hunting, they would use absolutely everything. Yeah. Like, there would be nothing left because it was a sign of respect. And I think that actually is better. Like, the animals that we have now as, like, our main source of food have been cultivated and have been raised to be a food source. Like, you don't see wild cows out and about.
Oh, yeah, that's 100,000.
They're not.
They're not wild as such.
They're free range.
Like, if you want to take an endangered species off the endangered species list, cultivate it for food. There'd be thousands, millions of them.
Well, look at chickens.
Yeah.
Look at like fish farming.
Oh yeah.
So much better to just like.
And it actually increases the population of them. Like, yeah, we eat a lot of them, but there's more of them that don't get eaten on a daily basis.
More sustainable to have a farm than catch it wild.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when it comes to kangaroos, though, they're all wild caught.
See, Australia is weird. We're the only country in the world that eats our own national animal.
Both of them, actually.
Yeah.
They taste amazing, by the way.
I've tried kangaroo. I wasn't a massive fan.
No. If you try kangaroo steak,
you're like, it's kind of like a weird sweetness to it.
No. If you try like a kangaroo steak, fucking shit. Don't try and eat it like a steak. But if you put it in like a stir fry or some shit, like,
or like a casserole or something.
Curry, but it's very so gamey. Good.
I could imagine like slow cooked kangaroo would be amazing. Like break down all like the fibrous tissue. Actually, kangaroo leather is actually the strongest leather on the planet. They have ridiculously strong skin. Oh yeah.
My brother used to have like a fucking Zach used to have a wallet made out of it, and like that motherfucker lasted for like.
Actually, very random fact. Actually, one of the best saxophones in the world, called the Force 5, uses kangaroo leather in one of its stoppers because it's specifically used because it's such strong leather that it won't break down. It won't wear down. Mm-hmm. Mm. She's just like, I don't fucking care about saxophones.
Did you know emus?
Do you know emus?
The cavalry units in the Australian Army use emus feathers in their hats, in their plumes. They're called plumes. And it dates back before World War I to prove who was the fastest rider on the horses. That you would be able to catch up to an emu and you're able to pull out a few feathers from it.
You also know that the Australian government once waged war on emus and lost.
We didn't lose.
But you didn't win either.
No.
They tried to kill over like 20,000 emus. They killed 1,000. They blew through 10,000 rounds of ammo. They lost.
You want to know that's even funnier about that?
What?
Australia is noted for being the first country to have a mechanized infantry because we put a stand gun on the back of a truck and followed. We were noted as being the first
mechanized. Because you were chasing emus.
Because we were chasing emus with a gun.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's fucking beautiful.
And you know the most messed up part is, you know why they waged war on the emus?
Because they were selling land to the farmers, and then the farmers were getting mad because they were coming and destroying their crops.
Why didn't they build better fences? Like, why would you not build a fence rather than wage war on birds?
Because they're in that time when war.
They just got back from war.
Just got back from war.
Why would they want to go do it again?
I think the thing that I like, this
is annoying, this place, isn't it?
Yeah, there's a lot of people around you.
We're talking about food and I'm just like so fucking hungry now.
Go get some food then.
Yeah, we'll get some food. And you're okay?
I'm getting impaled. Constantly.
Well, technically impaled.
I've been impaled.
Straight through. So you're getting stabbed.
You're getting penetrated. That's different. Yeah, impaled means going from one end all the way through the other.
Yeah.
I'm being stabbed.
That one.
Yeah. What do you call a three-humped camel?
Pregnant.
Yeah.
Zootopia joke.
I love
Zootopia.
Yeah.
I was obsessed with Zootopia for a little while.
See, I love it when Disney and Pixar do original stories like that and stop doing the freaking like remaking or the LGBT or whatever.
One more
like,
fucking movie or do a sequel of one more movie, I swear to fucking God, I'm going to burn down their headquarters.
Do Moana.
Yeah, I know. See.
Disappointment that you could hear from both of our voices.
Yeah. Like, I reckon that Disney and Pixar were being way more inclusive back in the day when they weren't trying.
Yes,
like Brother Bear, fucking Mulan, all of those other, those original Disney films were incredible because they weren't trying to be PC. They weren't trying to be woke as hell.
Do you know what made me really funny? In Aladdin, the main bad guy that was in it.
Jafar.
Yeah. Everybody got mad saying, why does he have a weird accent? Why are you making it an Arabic accent? And they're like, the actor who did it is British. He's actually speaking in a posh British accent.
Mm-hmm.
And then everybody was like, and then they just forgot about it. And I thought that was hilarious because they were up and roar about it. And the main bad guy was literally a British dude. Yeah. Did you know most of the bad guys in movies are actually British people?
Well, British is like, back in the day, England was at war with everyone.
Oh, fuck it.
Yeah.
No one fucking liked them.
They make the best villains because when you hear a posh person talking in a British villain accent, it's more imposing. Like, you wouldn't have a Canadian villain there, eh? Like, imagine your main villain talks like this, eh? Talks like a Canadian moose.
Fuck, you just got my Brother Bear in my head again.
Yeah. Fuck. Hey there, smallish bear. Hey. We're Mises.
All of the hills and all the mans. To plunder girls in Spain.
What? British Columbia.
Why are you saying that?
It's a song when the Napoleonic Wars happened, when the British Wellington Army went into Portugal and then went into Spain through that way. Over the hills and over the maze, to Flanders, Portugal and Spain, the king commands and I obey. Over the hills and over the way.
Isn't that like the theme song for like the movie you watch the show?
No, it's not the theme song. It was the original song that was used to keep soldiers in line.
But isn't it like played in the last turn?
Yeah. So it was a really, when you hit it on like the drums, it was really good for marching.
Yeah.
And it kept them in pace.
Why do I sing song like that anymore, huh?
Well, it's to increase morale. It's the same thing with sea shanties. Sea shanties were designed to be a rhythmic work song to keep sailors, like, energetic.
What's up?
Did you do
sea shanties?
When I was in the Navy?
Yeah.
A lot of the times we did, especially from
Manchester. Lever, Johnny, lever. She shipped a careen and none went by. And it's time for us to leave her.
That sounds so happy. They got that whole YouTube, what's it called? Irish song?
Oh, the Wellerman.
No, they have a whole video of like 10 sea shanties.
Okay. Yeah, that's a sea shanty medley done by the Home Free is their name.
I think
there's a few people who've done it.
There was one I used to sing all the time and it was about the galleon.
Was that Santiana? Oh, Northumbria, yeah. I think Santiana's one of my favorite. Oh, Santiana gained a day away. Santiana. Napoleon of the West, they say, along the plains of Mexico. Yeah, good song.
Those are the songs that I thought. But yeah, those were the things that you used to sing when I
did. Well, it works. I used to, whenever I was tattooing with the music on, I would actually have, like, in the playlist a couple of sea shanties going. And I would catch myself, like, tattooing along to the beat.
Yeah, they're just fucking beautiful.
Actually, there's a country song that I really like by Cooper Allen. It's called To the Bar. And it's the only way I can describe it is it's a mixture of a sea shanty, a Viking chant, and country. It's actually a really, really good song. It's got a good tempo to it.
There was a modern one that we used to sing all the time.
Looks like a sigil.
This one?
Strike. Yeah.
I didn't know what species he was, but he's cute.
He's in the holiday, tree frog.
So holiday means tree frog.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
H-Y-L-I.
Here we go, this is the one.
I learned a Latin word.
The last sea shanty is the one that came from, I think it was Ireland that it came from. And we used to sing this one all the fucking time. Because it was the modern navy, it was no longer the past navy.
Oh, I know that one, yeah.
No, it's just a man.
That's okay. If it's less than 8 seconds, it's fine.
Yeah, that was the point. I wanted to do the first couple of seconds just so I could jog memory. I wasn't going to play the entire thing.
I forget the name of
it. Is us singing it okay?
Yes. Because it's technically a cover then. It's not the original song.
But my father always told me when I was just a lad, a sailor's life is very hard, the food is always bad. But now I joined the Navy, I'm aboard a man of war. And I found a sailor ain't the sailor anymore. Don't haul on the ropes, don't climb up the mast. If you see a sailing ship, it might be your last.
I think I knew that one, yeah. Do you know the song, I Wanna Be in the Cavalry? Dun, 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 dun. I like that one.
I wanna be in the cavalry, like my forefathers
before me. Yeah.
But we sing the last shanty all the time because it was so unique to what we were doing, because it was about how it went from the sailing era to the modern naval era, and it's things that we weren't allowed.
They used that song in Sherlock Holmes, the one with Robert Downey Jr.
Really?
Yeah. The first one, because when he's remember when he's like going into dress up for that he's dressing up like the homeless man.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, the song is playing while he's chasing Ari Adler.
But I'm gonna have to watch that again.
Yeah.
But we used to sing that all the time because it was like the things that we used to be able to do. Like my thing was we used to have to climb up the mast a lot, but that was taken out of practice back in 2010.
Because you look like a pole dancer?
Well, no, it's because we had to go up and check the communication wires, but because it was too dangerous, we weren't allowed to do it anymore. And the joke was, well, we used to go up like almost 200 to 300 meters up a ladder back in the old sailing days, and now we're not even allowed to go up a fucking pole.
It's like, oh no, you'll hurt yourself.
Yeah.
Everyone's so sensitive.
But the officers are all saved. Did you know the most casualties in World War One was actually captains and lieutenants?
Was it from mutiny or friendly fire?
It was from, so back in World War One, they just came out of the age where senior commissioned officers or just commissioned officers needed to be brave and needed to show the men that it ain't nothing. So they used to lead by the front. So a lot of senior captains would get shot and killed really fast because they would stand up, blow their whistle, and then fucking go over the line, and then they'd get slaughtered.
You know the term mutiny? You know there's actually a term for when a captain disobeys his orders? It's called barratry.
Oh,
wow, that's something you didn't know, and it's military related.
Yeah, so like if the captain of a ship, the captain doesn't own that ship, they work for the owner of the ship. So if the captain of that ship goes against the owner's wishes, it's called barratry.
As long as the captain didn't fuck up, I'm pretty sure it'd be
alright. Beep, beep.
And there was a lot of creative freedom for senior ranking officers, especially the captain on board the ship. Mm. But we didn't really have the rank of captain. You wouldn't really see it on board the ships that I was on board. You would see it less than a commander. or a commander.
Yeah, I get really confused by all of the different ranks. Like, I don't know which one is more than another.
So there's a name that is actually called captain, which is rank.
Mm-hmm. And then there's a station for the captain. So you don't have the rank of captain, but you're the captain of that ship.
So the
that's confusing.
So the reason for that is because it's common respect, because they are the captain of the ship, the commander of the ship. They may not be the rank of a captain in the Navy, but they are the captain of the ship.
Oh, cool.
So you see a lot of commanders and lieutenant commanders who have been command of frigates, the smaller type of ships that captains would normally be on board, destroyers or frigates most of the time as well.
Mm. So what's the difference between a frigate and a ship? Is it just the size or?
Yeah, so it's size, what's being kept on board. Not really the shape, it's mainly the tonnage. The tonnage is the thing that separates all.
Okay, so what is the minimum requirement to be a ship? And I'm testing his knowledge here.
I believe it's about 100 meters in length to be classified as a ship. And I believe, I don't know what the smallest tonnage is, but I remember the ships that I served on were about 28,000 tons. And I know that the helicopter landing decks that we have in the Navy, which is the HMAS Canberra and the HMAS Adelaide, they are around about, I think it's 50 to 60,000 tons.
Mm-hmm. And does, like, say a destroyer, is that like a certain size as well, or is that just the name they give to certain ships?
No, a destroyer is normally bigger than a frigate, and it will be more of a punch, so it will have more offensive weapons.
Okay.
A frigate is a bit smaller, and it'll more likely have defensive weapons.
So, like, depth charges and stuff?
Yeah. So, frigates are actually made to keep the fleet safe. So, we kind of base it off how the Americans did theirs, and frigates and smaller ships there to guard the fleet from, like, torpedo boats and shit like that, and submarines.
Okay.
Where destroyers and cruisers, battleships and all that type stuff are there to fucking fight, and are there to fuck things up.
I saw a military training thing the other day where they were showing, like, the monetary value of, like, the training exercises. They were firing off a missile, and it was worth, like, $1.3 million. That was a house that you just blew up for no reason. And they run the minigun for like 10 seconds and it's like $12,000 of rounds.
Steve and I, when we both went down for the, I don't know if you got this when you're at Kapurka, but when I was at Kapurka, they constantly told us how much we were worth. And it was like $160,000 to train one Australian soldier.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because of the stuff they gave us, the weapons that they gave us, the rounds. I think I shot around easily 100 rounds out of the F-88 when I was down there. And if not more out of the F-89, which is the submachine.
They have a thing you shoot like a specific number of rounds.
Yeah. Mm, yeah, to get a certain rank or whatever. You know the sad part is?
Don't go off rank in the military.
You get it certified that you don't have.
You got to do like all these different exercises. You know, do all this like certifications before you can go into a rank.
Okay. You were saying it's about 160,000 to do a soldier. You know it's about 120,000 a year to keep a prisoner? Yeah, in prison with the housing, the security, the food, the medicine, and all of the other bits and pieces, it costs around $120,000 a year to keep a prisoner in prison.
Prisoners are just there to keep the civilians safe. It's not for their benefit, it's for the civilians' benefit to know that if you do something wrong, there's a consequence. But in my opinion, I think prisoners should be a part of a penal battalion.
It's either that or they should be doing service or like, you know how if you're a pensioner and you're living in a nursing home, you actually have to pay to be in there. Imagine if prisoners had to pay rent.
Oh, that would be so good.
Yeah, imagine that. Like, and if the prisoner can't afford it, then they go into doing like
what?
Community service. Like that would solve so many problems. And it would also probably be more of a deterrent as well, because going to jail, you can make money. You can make money in jail. Imagine like if you had to pay rent to be in jail.
In jail is where you get a full meal, you get a place to sleep.
People will commit federal crimes to get healthcare.
Jail. Yeah, you just get healthcare.
There was a guy in the States who robbed a federal bank for $1 because no hospital would look at him because he didn't have health insurance.
Do you know what's really, really funny?
What?
Australian healthcare is really good. But the homeless people still over here commit crimes to go to prison.
Yeah.
Because I've worked with them almost every single day, and every single day they'll always do some type of trespassing charge or something like that that won't hurt anybody, but they will go to prison.
Yeah, they'll commit non-violent crimes in a certain way so that they have to be put into jail.
I have literally seen a police officer say, "We're going to let you off on a warning, please don't do this," and he goes, "No, I want to go to jail." And the cops turned around and said, "We do not have room at the fucking jail for you."
Mm. Otherwise, we'd have to transfer you, which would cost more money. Isn't that so sad, though, that the prospect of being in jail is better than being outside for a lot of people?
Fuck, yeah.
Like, that is a real definition of how fucked we are as a society, that people would rather go to jail than live out here.
I've worked in the correctional facilities with a company called... Bleep.
we will not use names of companies here.
So I've worked with a...
A company who shall remain unnamed.
That worked with the Queensland government and the federal government. And they would hire out security officers to go there. So if there's not enough people to guard the prisons, they will literally sell the prisons to a private organization to oversee the security maintenance.
I have heard this, that they have been selling prisons as private enterprises now.
Holy shit, is it corrupt as fuck? Because
it's basically Shawshank Redemption, where they use the prisoners for fucking forced labor and then they take bribes from other people.
So fucking bad. Because there's like one guard for about 200 prisoners.
Oh yeah. If they decided to rise up, the prison guards would have no chance.
When I worked in it, we were literally told specifically.
Specifically?
Shut up.
My wife does the same thing. She can't say specific.
If anything happens, to evacuate the center, hop in the car and drive away from the prison and get around about 5 to 10 kilometers away and then call the police.
Mm-hmm. Always just
take them about an hour to an hour. It will take them literally half an hour to an hour to get re-chewed at about 10 to 5 kilometers.
Mm-hmm.
So if they were going after you in particular because they don't like a guard, they'll take you longer and police would arrive before.
Mm.
But yeah, if anything like really happened, we couldn't really go
anywhere. Oh, it's so sad, isn't it?
And it was in the whole entire prisons that I worked at were built around rehabilitation and getting certifications in agriculture. You can probably figure out which prison that is. No, I'm kidding. There's hundreds of them that do it. In there were
I'm not really familiar enough with prisons to know.
Well, a lot of the Australian prisons in the rural areas deal with agriculture certifications and stuff like that. So when you come out, you can be a farmhand and stuff like that. So you can make money.
See, I like when they do that. I like when they actually enforce like learning and rehabilitation so that they're not being let out into the world like more blind than they were when they went in.
Well, that's the whole entire point. Our prisons.
It's supposed to be to make them.
Center.
It's to make them citizens, essentially. It's like it's making them like get skills and contribute and stuff
but
like
the
that.
The problem was when I was working there, there was only so many prisoners and there was only so many classes that were available. And they would intentionally make it small so they didn't have to pay an educator so much money or they didn't have to pay out an amount of money to teach these people. I'm like, what? What's the point of putting him in jail for like?
If you're not going to actually rehabilitate them.
Sit him in a cell for 8 hours a day, talking to their cell for 24 hours a day, sitting and talking to their cellmates, getting to know them. You're just teaching them more crime.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're basically surrounding them with people who may not.
Criminal university.
Yeah.
It's
indoctrination in such a way. Like people go in, like people can be sent in there and actually be innocent of the crime, but come out criminals. So that's pretty much the outline and most of the shading done. Do you feel up to the color?
It looks so cool like this.
We can at least do the frogs.
Yeah.
Because we can probably leave the leaves till later if you want.
Oh, that's the other question that I was going to say. Are you free next week at the same time?
I will have to have a look. Let's see.
That is so
if
cool.
If so, we'll book you out for next week as well.
Like-
yeah, you can stand up and have a stretch.
Okay.
Get up. Get to there. Alright, so where's the little frog man going? Side of here?
Yep.
Okay.
And facing me, if that's alright.
Yeah, that's fine.
Is that alright?
No, yeah. I can draw him upside down. That's what I did with the last one.
Can you not speak for the artist, please?
You don't ever play you want it.
You're the person who's gonna get us kicked out.
Kicked out.
No, we're not allowed back here. You've insulted him.
I think that's the one thing that would fuck me up if I did this job.
Doing things upside down.
Yep, I can't do it.
Honestly, perspective has been one of those things that's kind of lost meaning for me. I do things upside down, backwards, side to side. Like, drew them sideways, drew him upside down. This will be no difference.
That's a good fucking point, actually. It's only now that I noticed it. Do you have inspectors that come to you, like, randomly?
Yeah, every couple of months. I've actually tattooed one of my health inspectors several times.
Is that allowed?
But I don't see why not. He's allowed to do whatever he wants in his free time.
That's a good point.
Okay.
So they actually do come around here often?
Yeah. Every 6 months or so. So you're going to lose a little bit of the pizza behind him unless I move it around a little bit more.
Yeah, if that's all right.
So I'll move him that way?
Yeah.
Cool.
Sorry.
It's all right. I just don't want to lose any of the design. All right. Time for some cute little frogs.
If you need to hold my hand, let me know.
I'm sure he'd appreciate that. Emotional support and all that.
Ah!
It hurts.
You haven't started yet.
The anticipation.
Don't hear, that's mean.
Hurting me.
Oh, what are you doing? For a married couple, you sure sound like siblings.
That's probably weird.
Hey, you're the ones doing it, not me.
Best friends. I guess that's the best way I can describe it.
His mother thinks of me as daughter, and here is her 2-year-old son.
It's all right. Me and the wife started off as best mates as well.
Please stop making it out to be incest, please.
How kind of videos are you watching?
No videos, robots.
Now you've made it weird. She's just like, oh God, why did I have to bring him?
I'm sorry.
No, you're not.
I'm waiting for my phone to strike. No.
Girl, break all that. You know, like, you know, like, when your family was like this little, we'd like tie the knot. I love to do that. We should do like 5 years of me.
You know what that's based off of? Yeah, the hand fasting. Where it's like you're married for a year and a day, and then after that year you decide whether you actually want to be like permanently married.
Yeah, let's do that, huh?
Aren't you guys already married?
Yeah. But not a year.
Can we reverse it?
No, it's called unbreakable for a reason.
See, I'm stuck with you.
Yeah, you can't divorce an unbreakable vow, unfortunately. Oh, sorry. Can't have this. Camera's on.
Oh.
So that first little bit I'm going to have to cut.
Can you please start singing for me that song specifically?
Specifically?
Bad habits.
Do you? Yeah. Oh, wow.
Oh, you blushing.
I'm not brushing. I'm embarrassed.
Brushing.
Fuck, I'm tired. How do you actually buy this stuff? Do you have to buy it online?
Yes. You can't just go down the road and get this shit.
Yeah, I was thinking so. There was no special in-person shop.
There is a couple of places in Surfers that are like tattoo shops that do have like surplus. But nah, I get all my stuff online.
Does it come from the US?
Most of it's made in the US. But yeah, the distributor we have here is Australian, but a lot of the products, like my tattoo machines and a lot of the needles, are made in the US. There was actually a point where we couldn't get a lot of stuff from the US because there was a massive embargo on like trade and shit when Trump was in office.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise
me. It was a little infuriating.
Technically, if you're in the military, you know that little about politics.
We're not.
There are opinions and then there are facts.
There's a reason why. It's in case if we talk about our opinions too much, it could lead to a...
investigation?
Well, somebody could be like, hey, you don't like this guy? No, I don't. Well, me and these other lads don't like him either.
Oh, an insurrection.
Yeah. Oh, gossip isn't allowed in the military as well.
No. Are you girls at a water cooler or are you men?
Well, no, it's because gossip can create...
gossip can create dissent, is that the... unruly?
Cohesion in the unit.
Incohesion.
I don't like this guy.
So the, technically that would make it a solvent if it wasn't cohesive. Practicing your secret handshake.
Are you okay?
Jeez. I was going to say,
you fucking hurt yourself or what?
Can I have like really dark blue for the... There was one that was used on this called steel blue or something like that, I think.
Yeah, I think I know the one.
This looks really, really dark. Look as far as light out.
Yeah, if you start darker, it does eventually lighten up with most colors.
I like the dark blue. It's my favorite.
I like the
darkness. Hello, darkness, my old friend. Come to talk with you again.
You know the guy who's saying that actually committed suicide, which is the most saddest thing about the entire thing?
Mm. It's kind of like with Chester Bennington, that song One More Light. Hearing that now always makes me want to cry because...
Oh, what's his name? The guy who...
We'll wait for you.
No, the guy who passed away is like the best singer in like the 2000s. Like so many songs.
Avicii.
Avicii, though. I didn't know that.
Yeah, he passed away in a...
Oh, look, now you just ruined someone else's date. We're so sorry.
It's all right.
I mean, the guy who did Starlight and Star Wars recently passed from...
Mark Hamill?
No, what's his name? Not the guy in Star Wars passed away recently.
Oh, James Earl Jones. James Earl Jones, yeah. He was also Mufasa.
I loved him.
Yeah, there was, after he died, there was like everyone now feels like Simba and the Lion King's like, come on, you gotta wake up. Yeah, that. Oh, dude, that. You know that stampede scene took a team of, I think, 10 animators almost like 9 months to animate because they had to animate each individual wildebeest?
That doesn't surprise
me. By hand? It's like, Jesus. Yeah, they spent that much time on one of the most traumatic scenes ever. And another one that took a ridiculous amount of time was in one of the Star Wars prequels, I think it was number 2, there's a scene where they're sitting on the grass on a separate planet with Anakin and Padme, and the animators had to go in and they had to basically paint out every single little bug that was in that scene because there were flies and like little insects everywhere. But they actually had to go in and hand paint out every single one of them. It took like 4 or 5 months or something ridiculous.
That explains a lot of why the last image in the movie makes it look so weird.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's do it.
Oh, here comes the needle.
Not so bad, is it?
That's really good. I'm quite surprised for how far I went. Look, that's it.
I'm very light-handed.
It's good.
So besides the Souls games, what would be your favorite type of game? It's like DayZ or whatever?
No. I would say I got big into Skyrim.
Mm-hmm.
What? Well, that would be awesome. One of the...
See, I never played the original ones. Like, I only ever played Skyrim. I never played... what was the one before it? Morrowind?
Yeah, no, I never played those either. Skyrim was just where I went. Because I couldn't really get into the other games.
Mm. I never played Elder Scrolls Online.
Yeah, I didn't know that. I played it like once and it was crap.
It's kind of like the Fallout 76 or whatever it was. I never bothered with that.
I got so hyped for the release.
And then it came out and you're just like, oh.
I was so pissed because I spent like $160 on it.
So what actually was it? Was it like you created your own vault or whatever and you had to have friends or...
No. So you had the own vault and everything like that. It was literally a storyline just with multiplayer.
But I hate games that do that. But it needs to have like a single player campaign with the option to do
multiplayer. But they didn't, which pissed me off.
Mm.
And pissed off everyone because at some points in the campaign you would need a second person. And you're like, well, fuck you, I don't have any friends that want to do this with me, or you're like, it's hard to get other people to do it with you.
Mm.
The other thing that fucking pissed me off was the people who were online, like, most of them were trolls.
Mm-hmm. That's most online games anyway, and that's why I don't like playing online. Yeah. See, it can be an amazing game, but the second that other people come on and start to ruin it for you, I'm instantly out.
Yeah.
Like, I never did Red Dead Redemption online. I never did, I never did, like, Battlefield or anything like that, because I just knew that it was going to be a trolling thing. Like, my goddaughter plays Fortnite, and some of the things that I hear on Fortnite are just like, whoa, she should not be hearing any of this.
My nephews are like that. Oh, my God.
They're tame compared to what I used to do when I was on Battlefield and Call of Duty.
Like
Call of Duty and Battlefield are the only ones that I played on multiplayer, and my...
You got cancelled.
Oh, man. If we had those days again, like the amount of stuff that was said on the Call of Duties and stuff like that, so bad.
See, I don't get how that's entertaining, though. Like, there's friendly banter, and then there's just being...
A din.
Yeah.
Yeah, obviously the friendly banter was all funny and stuff like that. I don't think anybody in my group really went that extreme to, like, bully people.
Actually, one of my favorite things that I ever saw online was that group Anonymous. They were hired by this girl who kept getting abused by this one player online, and they found all of his information. They found him on a gaming server, and they started, like, trolling him back, saying, like, we know where you live. We're going to disclose your freaking address and everything unless you apologize to her. And he was just like, what the fuck? And they actually made him, like, sing an apology and stuff like that as well online. I'm just like, that is brilliant. Troll the troll, I say.
Damn right. They fucking deserve it, some of those guys.
Mm-hmm. I just don't get how they can get enjoyment out of it. It's like, there's poking fun, there's, like, being mean, and then there's just, like, you're trying to ruin someone's life. Like, the ones who are just like, oh, you should fucking kill yourself, or, oh, why are you on here, you fucking pussy, or whatever. It's like, you know.
Just absolute cunts, like.
Yeah, there's no need for that. They're just trying to have fun, they're just trying to play a game. It's supposed to be a relaxing time, not stressed out fucking horror show. Bullying's bad enough in schools and everywhere else. We don't need it in gaming.
No.
That's actually another thing as well that I thought a few weeks ago, is that bullying back in the day was you had to say everything to someone's face. Nowadays, there's so much anonymity. There's so much, like, online presence. These fucking keyboard warriors just...
You get away with it.
Oh, yeah. And it's so much worse now. Like, young people are fucking killing themselves, man, because of, like, shit people say online to them. Social media is easily one of the worst things that humanity has ever invented. Like, it's done some good. It's done some good, but it is also one of the worst things for this upcoming generation.
Just like the internet, and then on the other side of the internet, you have the darknet.
Oh, yeah.
There's goods and bads, but, like, the fucking, I think it's, like, 10% of the websites are a top of the iceberg, and, like, 90% of the websites are, like, dark underneath.
Yeah, like, the fact that there is an entire, like, server system dedicated to fucking, like, child trafficking and shit like that, I'm just like, what the hell? The fact that people have gotten smart enough to do this shit for such nefarious purposes. Like, when I watched that that movie that came out not long ago, The Sound of Freedom. Did you ever see that?
Yep.
Dude, that movie made me fucking cry. That was so sad. That's actually what's happening.
It fucked me for a while.
Yeah.
The smart criminals. Like, you
the smart criminals are the dangerous ones, man.
You don't even know. That's the thing. You don't get told about their stories. You get told about these stories because we found out about it, or the police found out about it and did an investigation. The smart criminals never get found.
Oh, like, we're only seeing, like, maybe 5% of the people who are dumb enough to get caught.
I'll guarantee.
And
most of the time they get caught because they're overconfident.
Mm-hmm.
Where most of the
they got cocky.
Didn't get fucking away with that.
Like, the fact that we have more people in slavery today than when slavery was actually legal, that blows my goddamn mind.
Yeah.
And, like, 60% of them are children, man. And I found it fascinating with that movie that it took them, like, 6 years or something for it to get released because they had to go through so much bureaucratic bullshit to have it shown.
Epstein Island?
Mm-hmm.
park.
Yeah, you know his little black book of all of his people that were associated with him sold for like $12 million or something?
Yep.
In auction? I'm just like, what? That should have been turned over to the cops. Why was that shit sold at a private auction?
I don't understand why half those motherfuckers haven't been arrested.
People in high places?
100%. And every single time, like, names got released, there was always something else going on.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for instance, remember those rich boys decided that it would be a great idea to go down to the Titanic?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The US Navy knew that they were dead ages.
Their air pressure's too much to do.
Their air pressure, you could already see the explosion, and it happened, like, days before. But they kept milking it because the release of the new Epstein Island list was coming out.
It's one of those things where they shoot a lot of these things on a delay just in case.
Yeah.
And it's about keeping people ignorant long enough so that they can build their stories.
So fucking funny.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking pisses me off that type of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Don't like, get me wrong, there's good humans out there and there's good people out there. But
some of them do exist. I meet quite a few of them.
Yeah, 100% good ones are bad. There's always bad people with them.
Oh, yeah. You need to have balance. That's the main thing. It's just about choosing which side is the dominant side.
Can I say something really fucking nerdy?
It's not possible.
Can I say something really fucking nerdy?
Sure.
It kind of reminds me of Star Wars. Like, the whole entire idea was Anakin was supposed to bring balance to the Force.
And he did.
He did.
He cut down the light side enough to actually bring the Sith up to power again.
Because there was 20,000 light Jedi at the time, and I'm like, that's
misread the prophecy could have been.
That's not fucking balance, my boy.
Yeah, like, balance doesn't mean get rid of all of the dark. That means eradication. Light and dark need to be balanced. So instead of creating more Sith, which would make more balance, he got rid of most of the light.
I think the only time that it was actually fully balanced is probably during the Old Republic days during the war.
Mm-hmm. Like, are they ever going to do an origin story of, like, Darth Plagueis and Darth Sidious and shit like that? Because I would love to see that. Or, like, an origin story of Yoda when he was, like, a youngling and then going up through his training would be
awesome. I want to see that, but the one thing that I'm scared of is they're going to fuck it.
Yeah.
I don't trust it.
What do you think of the fallout in the series?
I've watched one episode. I haven't gotten far enough into it yet.
I love it. I like it. Correction, I like it. I don't love it. But the thing that pissed me off is Sadie Sands.
Oh?
I have so many fucking questions. The New California Republic, the NCR, is my fucking, that is my shit.
Mm-hmm.
And it's fucking gone. And it's
lore. Yeah, that was a massive thing in like Fallout 3, wasn't it? Yep. New Vegas?
Yep.
That was actually my favorite Fallout game.
And I have questions. I'm like, where the fuck is my NCR, boys?
Mm.
That was my point.
That might be season 2.
Season 2 is hopefully they're going to say, oh, the NCR is here. They're okay. Or the remnants of the NCR are here. And if that's the case, I'm going to be all right. But if there's no NCR and it's like just obliterated, I'm going to be so angry.
Yeah, and they need to have the two-headed bear come back.
But we feel like we're going to go to the Commonwealth next. And if we go to the Commonwealth, they have two ways of going about it. Number one, the Minutemen won the main campaign of Fallout 4, which means that they've gotten along with everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Or number two,
it's going to be the Institute.
It's going to be the Institute or the Brotherhood.
Mm-hmm.
But because we only saw
the Brotherhood's boring though.
I don't like the Brotherhood.
I've done the Brotherhood campaign once and I would never do it again.
They're so hypocritical and it pisses me off. Because they're like, weapons are bad, but we'll keep it all to ourselves.
But we have all the big laser weapons.
And I'm like, isn't that what the United States did, my boy?
Kinda.
And then other people got mad that they kind of kept it all to themselves.
Mm-hmm. It's like weapons are bad if the enemy has them. If we have them, it's okay because we can control them and stop other people from having them.
Yes.
It smells a methylated spirit.
Oh, if that was methylated spirits, he'd be hitting the roof. This is Dettol, distilled water, and green soap.
It's kind of weird that I kind of want to lick it.
Don't do that.
It's just like the thing that I want to do. Can I lick it?
You know, I should have a essential oil, the thing is called like cool mist, and it's like made almost like smells like
mist.
So you know that stuff that you have on your chest?
Vicks.
It smells like very strong to Vicks. People love it because it's also into the person at the market.
Oh, yeah.
She says really, really good. Everyone loves it.
Isn't that like eucalyptus and menthol and stuff?
Yeah.
Vicks is one of those things that's like, it hasn't changed since it was first made.
Because it's fucking perfect. Why change something that's perfect?
Tiger balm.
Tiger balm too. Although, tiger balm has started being outdone by something else.
Mm. Horse oil?
I think so.
So we're going to give this little frog a name?
I was going to say slave. He's
the pack mule.
No, I think he's more like I don't think he's a fellow traveler. I think he's a, what's the word? When you get an animal in a game.
A daemon.
Yeah. I think that's just what he is. He's not like an actual thing.
Summon?
Yeah, he's just like a summon.
Okay, so he's
that follows him around.
It's like the jellyfish in fucking Elden Ring.
Yeah, exactly. That's how I saw the frog as. I never really saw it as like another thing. I just
saw it as like another traveler.
He could be the bard. He could be like the little one who like sings and brings up your morale.
Well, I thought the knight was lonely, so the knight decided to summon the frog.
Oh yeah, it's like I need someone to talk to.
Knight and the frog came together around the fire.
Hmm. I love how we're creating a backstory for these two.
It's the backstory that I'm going to be telling everybody from now.
Yeah, this is the deep lore. This is the canon. This is the head canon.
Mine's just frogs.
Frogs.
Just the river.
Hi, hole. I'm on your arm.
You're in the wrong form.
It isn't easy being green.
Go back the way you came.
Why does it, like, when you look in a mirror and the two mirrors face each other, get that, like, psychedelic?
Because it's an infinite hallway, because it's an infinite reflection of a reflection.
Yeah.
Imagine if we could jump into that.
You know, there actually is a theory that when you look into a mirror, you're looking into the next parallel dimension to you, where only one thing is different, and every mirror reflection after that, like you could see like 1,000 reflections, and one of them you'd be holding up 2 fingers, and then one you'd be holding up 1. Yeah. That's the theory. The mirror dimension. But yeah, when we found out that it was an infinite hallway with the mirrors, it was just like, oh, that's kind of neat. It makes the shop look huge. But then when people don't notice it for like an hour or so and they look up, they're just like, oh my God, I can see forever.
I can see into the soul.
I can smell the cosmos. What about the knight? What are we calling him? What do you normally call your Dark Souls character?
Whoa.
Yeah.
W-O.
Mm.
See, my name's Nature Girl.
Whoa.
I go with WOW because it stood for Warrant. It stands for Warrant Officer,
mm-hmm.
which is the rank that I wanted to be in the army.
Interesting.
But I never fucking made it.
So, woe to the fact that you never became WOW?
Yeah. It was also supposed to be really simple so people could add me on Discord.
Mm.
So, what's your name? W-O-2-1-1-6.
What's 2116 mean?
That was the hashtag. So when they first came out, you had a hashtag and you had an individual number on Discord.
I always name my character after my favorite anime character.
What's that?
Alucard.
What's that one called?
Helsing. It's actually it's a really sick anime. The Helsing OVA only has, I think, 10 episodes. The original one's a bit longer, but it's not as close to the source material. So basically what it is, Alucard is Dracula backwards. So the Van Helsing family managed to essentially capture the body of Dracula and turn him into a weapon that fights against monsters. And who's not one? So he was found in the basement by the next descendant of the Helsing organization after her father died. And
We know where this is going.
Hmm?
I just said he, her, I know exactly.
No, none of that happens. There's no sexual relationship between them at all. He's basically a thrall to her. Like he respects her. Like when she finds him, she's actually being hunted by her uncle, who thought that he was going to inherit the organization, but her father left it to her because his brother was a bit of a dick. So he ends up chasing her down to the basement, and she gets into the basement and her uncle shoots her, and some of the blood goes down to where the corpse of Alucard is sitting. So he's sitting there basically in a fucking straitjacket, just dead, mummified.
Yeah.
But the blood manages to hit him. And because that's the first blood he's tasted in however long, he actually becomes bound to her.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah. So he's now basically like, he will do anything for her. And he's a really, really cool character. He's voiced by one of my favorite voice actors called Crispin Freeman. Oh, dude, I wish I had that guy's voice.
Like Morgan Freeman? No.
He's basically like a white Morgan Freeman mixed with a James Earl Jones.
Oh my God, that's awesome.
It's so good. Like, if you look him up on YouTube, Alucard, one of the coolest voices in anime, and he carries these two guns that are like this long each. They're ridiculous. He's got this long, flowing red trench coat, big fuck off.
Oh, fuck, yes, I have seen that.
Yeah.
Yes, I've seen it, yes.
Yeah, he's awesome. Wears white gloves.
Sorry, I
cool ass glasses. You needed the character description.
Yes, I have seen that. Yes, that is fucking awesome.
But yeah, like one of the first lines he says in the series is like, "Beautiful night, isn't it, police girl? Especially if you're a bloodsucker."
And he makes an absolute...
He makes a mess of people. He turns them into freaking blood soup. Absolute maniacal bastard. And the entire thing with this series is that they're fighting Nazis.
Oh.
Fucking Nazi vampires, werewolves. They even have a physical manifestation of Schrodinger's cat. His name is Vaunt Officer Schrodinger. He is everywhere and nowhere.
Is he actually real?
He exists in the series. He's actually pretty integral to how the story goes.
What?
But yeah, it's one of my favorites. But I always name my characters and games after him. Alucard, not Schrodinger.
Never mind. I lost.
Specify.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Full-time tattoo artist, part-time thesaurus.
Thank you. That's good. I need that. Maybe I could just start walking around with them thesaurus.
You have one. It's in your phone.
It's called your wife.
Yeah, you can literally install a thesaurus on your phone. So you can say like, "Hey, thesaurus, what's another word for this?"
Yeah, that actually makes a lot of sense. So I probably should do that.
Look at these dudes just chilling around the fire.
Chair that's made
entirely
I told you. It's so comfy, isn't it? Yeah, for like $100, it's probably one of the most comfortable like chairs I've ever actually sat in.
You know, you can like go to sleep on it and you can just like push it back.
That'll stop snoring.
Oh, that's all right.
I don't snore.
Yes, you do.
I love when people say, "I don't snore." You physically have no way of knowing that unless someone tells you.
I'm telling you right now.
I don't know. I don't think I snore. I'm a very light sleeper.
That has nothing to do with snoring.
That was
Oh, yeah, you talk about anything and the thing shows up with it. I was talking to someone about cars the other day, and I'm not a car person in the slightest. I don't follow any car pages. I do none of that shit. My entire Facebook reel was nothing but cars. It's like Zuckerberg is listening.
I did. Didn't he just go for a lawsuit for that?
Probably. It's not as bad as TikTok and stuff like that. You know that...
That's owned by the Chinese government.
Probably.
No, 100%. It was proven. That's the whole entire reason why India banned it.
I didn't know that.
India banned TikTok because the Chinese government was in control of it. And India, if you don't know, fucking hates China. Like... They have, like, India and China hate each other more than the Chinese and the Americans hate each other.
Interesting. I never knew there was a beef between the two.
Oh, fuck, man. There is a full beef.
For what? Was it, like, spices, land, religion?
Land.
Okay. So is it worse than the British and the Indians?
Oh, 10 times worse. They fucking hate each other.
I've never heard of this.
They have clashes on the border. Once a month.
I did not know that.
Yeah, I think there's been like a total of 1,000 soldiers lost in total in the last probably couple of years of border clashes between India and China.
Huh.
Where they'll just start beating the fuck out of each other.
Goddamn. That was one I never even thought was an issue. I never thought that they had any, like, any beef.
It's so bad that there is a United Nations Defense Pact that has, like,
neutral ground.
Neutral soldiers that go there to make sure that they...
Like border patrol soldiers sort of thing.
So they don't try and kill each other.
Holy crap.
Because they would 100% make a war. They hate each other.
It makes me sad sometimes how ignorant I am of actually what's going on in the world all the time.
I think the scariest thing is both of them have nuclear weapons and massive armies.
Mm-hmm.
And there's more of a chance of them two starting a war than China and America starting.
What about America and Russia?
With how things are going now?
Yeah.
Oh, that blood. I'm bleeding a little.
I made you bleed your own blood.
Yeah, right. Oh, fuck. I love that blue.
Mm-hmm. It's got a little bit of light with a little bit of dark. You know, the sad part is that there is probably, I think the last estimated count was like 200,000 nuclear devices on the planet.
Yeah. I think the most hypocritical thing about it is the Americans turned around and were like, no one else is allowed to have nuclear weapons. It's illegal. But we can have them.
Yeah, isn't like the mad mutually assured destruction pact that it's like no chemical weapons?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or I don't know if it was nuclear as well.
No, it's both.
Mm.
It's nuclear and chemical weapons.
Because isn't, yeah, that's considered a war crime.
Chemical weapons? Yes. Yeah. Technically, yes, depending on where you use them, what you use them for. Phosphorus is a war crime if you shoot it directly on infantry or any type of...
So those are the incendiary rounds, yeah?
Yeah.
White
They're
phosphorus,
the ones that literally make you burn and it does not stop.
Mm-hmm. It's like wildfire.
Yeah. So you can't use incendiary devices as a direct offensive weapon, but you can use them... For smoke cover and defensive.
What?
Because phosphorus gas is a phosphorus is really good to make smoke shields.
Huh.
So you can put a smoke shield in between you and the enemy, and if the wind just happens to be flowing towards the enemy...
It's not a direct assault.
It's not a direct hit on the enemy.
You know that back in the day, they actually were trying to come up with an idea for a gay bomb? They were trying to find hormones in a gas that would actually turn the enemy soldiers gay for each other so they wouldn't be focused on the fight.
That would probably work, to be honest. I think that, well, all you got to do is just get a shit ton of Viagra and just put it in the gas form. That would fucking work.
The V-bomb.
That would fucking work, to be honest. Just give him a whole bunch of fucking... sexual steroid hormones release.
Well, yeah, like pretty much all it would be is just like turning off the inhibitors. So like give them the sexual drive, but turn off inhibitors. There was actually that movie that Chris Hemsworth was in where they did that. They literally created those little injection things that made you like super freaking horny. Doesn't matter who's in front of you.
Yeah. That would be the shit.
Yeah. Imagine that. Like the US was fucked today by themselves.
An unknown terrorist organization is taking claims for making a new type of chemical bomb today.
Hi, sis. That would just be the thing that ruined the States, just them to be ruined by a gay bomb.
I like how we started speaking about Australia and this is what happens.
Yeah. Aussie.
Oh, fuck.
These are all of Australian standard service rifles over the last century, starting off with the short mag Lee Enfield Mark III. This officially entered service in 1908.
Oh, no, too much.
I was going to say, you guys at the end of a business meeting or something? Why are you shaking hands?
It made me wobble too much.
Wibbly wobbly.
Wobble wobble. That was a bit of a painful one. But he's finished with the knives.
No, I'm not.
Oh.
Yeah, he is.
Never mind.
Still got to do the yellow and the highlights on the night.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Yeah.
The more and more I look at it, the more and more detail I see in it.
Yeah, it's a very simplistic design, but simplistic has to be done well. So there is a lot involved in it. Because when you have like a, what we call basic design, there's less room for error. So going back to Dark Souls, who would be your favorite boss? Or the one that gave you the most trouble?
Is it bad that I don't know their names?
All right, is it a beginning boss or an ending boss?
No, nah, fucking beginning boss.
Mm-hmm.
I'd say not the first boss, but the second one.
Is that the dancer one?
He's the one who threw a coffin at you.
Oh, I know the one. Yeah, I forget the name as well.
Fucking hated him. Did he throw it? No.
Was it the one in the church?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that's a chick. Turns into that big white beast, throws a coffin at you.
Can't remember.
Me either.
Would have to confirm.
Mm-hmm. Can either deny or confirm.
Yes. It's been a while since I last played Dark Souls. It kind of pissed me off a lot. Mm. That and also it's kind of mixed together because I'm starting to play Elden Rings now.
Have you played the DLC yet?
No.
Ooh. Actually, you're lucky because the DLC, the final boss has been fucking nerfed. My God, when he wasn't nerfed, he was almost impossible.
Did you beat him?
Oh, yeah. I beat him twice. But the first time I was fighting him, holy crap. And the way that the Dark Souls DLC, sorry, not the Dark Souls, the Elden Ring DLC works, it's not based on your current level. So you can go in at max level and you'll still get fucked up because the strength and everything is not based on that on the previous world's attributes. You actually have to build up your new attributes through skidoo tree fragments and such.
That fucks me up.
So you're basically starting at level one going into the DLC. It doesn't matter how strong your weapons are. Doesn't matter any of that shit. Which I think is actually really good. Miyazaki thought about it in such a way where it's like, okay. So you got all these people who've played the shit out of Elden Ring. They're at max level. They're just like, oh, this fucking DLC is going to be a cakewalk. Ha ha ha. Fuck you. And the combat system is so fucking good. They have even like entire new weapon sets. Like they have unarmed ones. So they have like a martial arts based one. They have one where like...
Unarmed. Oh my God.
Yeah, you're basically... Yeah, you have a monk style one, you have...
we're going into D&D now.
Yeah, great katana, you got backwards curved blades, so you have ones that you hold the blades backwards. Honestly, they were my favorite. I beat the entire game with this. Yeah, they even have throwing weapons now. Like you have throwing axes, you have throwing knives, you even have a throwing hammer.
Cool.
Yeah, they're like unlimited number of throwing things. Just cost stamina to throw them. And they even have a... not a potions bottle, but it's like, so it's like this bottled and you can either throw lightning, you can throw fire, poison.
Yeah,
so,
I get you.
So like an elemental flask sort of deal. And it was actually quite fun, like just going through and trying the different types that I've never tried on Elden Ring before. But then going back to the main game, you can just blitz through the entire fucking game once you've beaten the DLC. There will be a fight, however, that will fuck you up because it fucked me up and it fucked up most people who I saw played it. There's a black knight in a crypt, like at the very beginning of the game. So like when you come out and you go into the DLC area, you can either turn right or you can turn left. If you turn left, one of the first things you can go into is like a little crypt downstairs. This dude has, like, the best armor in the game for a long time, so recommend trying to fight him, but took me probably about 20 tries to kill him the first time.
Like, fighting him with, like, max stats?
Oh, this was, like, when you have nothing. Like, this is when you don't even realize that your stats mean nothing.
So you should be fighting him then?
Oh, I tried fighting him then, and I fucked myself up, but I eventually managed to get him. I
was going
to
say, there'd be no fucking way. What?
Yeah, so I would go and try him, just so you can see what I mean, and then maybe go grind for a little bit. But he has, like, the best armor at that beginning of the game.
I love the grind.
Mm. The deep grind.
Although, I'm going to have to get it all back on my laptop because I played on PS4.
I play on PS5. Almost done with this, guys.
It's therapeutic. Yes. I've been wanting this guy for so long.
Mm-hmm. For too long. She wants to watch you in pain.
Hmm?
All right. Little Frog and his friend are done.
Woo!
Woot, woot. Yeah.
No, stop. They're matching.
Probably shouldn't
don't
touch.
Touch it.
Yeah, don't touch it, you dink.
You guys get the wipe again.
That's fine. All right, so are we doing the beer into pizza?
Well, I wanted to get the kind of that one.
Okay.
So you think you can do that one?
Yeah, I can do that one. Where do you want to put them?
I was thinking like right there.
Right on the hand?
Fuck on it. The hand? You sure?
Now, are you doing him upside down, or are you doing him, like, right way facing?
I don't know.
Like, do you want the horns coming up onto the fingers? Do you want them coming up onto the wrist?
I kind of want them coming up to the fingers so I can see him.
Okay.
So it's my type of thing.
That'll be sick.
But I don't know.
Well, I'll draw it on and we'll see what we think.
These are, like, the two big ticket items that I want it done.
Okay.
And that, and also the... There was only three that I majorly wanted, which was the first one, this one, and the frog with a beer and a pizza.
Okay.
Which are the main problem.
I
can't get them all done, that's fine.
Well, what's the time now?
3:07.
Wait,
for we should be able to get all of them done. I don't see why not.
Damn.
Yeah, like that one only took me, what, like an hour?
Yeah.
So if we say an hour each, that's... It's not bad. That actually works out quite nicely.
You have a very hairy arm.
Hairy boy.
You gotta be so mean to me.
Because it's fun.
We're so used to shaving our body hair.
Huh?
I think in the future.
Can you
let me finish?
Okay.
No.
As it says in the future, if you think that if we shave our body hair so much that we've grown out of tension, we don't need hair anymore.
That would take a long time if it's an evolutionary trait.
You know people don't have wisdom teeth anymore? There's babies that grow without wisdom teeth.
So this generation that's coming up is going to be stupid?
Yeah.
Yeah, sounds about right.
They have no wisdom to give.
Mm-hmm.
Should we want one on the hand?
Yeah.
Well, we're going to see.
Well, he's already doing it now, so there's no getting out.
I can wipe it off.
No. I want it.
It's like, gimme. Gimme, 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 gimme.
Still on the hand?
Maybe.
Yeah, the hand is very spicy, not going to lie.
Spicy.
It's the best way to describe a tattoo. Hot, painful.
Yeah, no, I can feel the heat off mine. It's like a sauna.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of like a sunburn mixed with like a mild scratch. It's the best way to describe it, personally. All right, so we're all done for the day. So I wanted to thank Simone and Seth for coming through, getting some awesome tats. Got lots of frogs and one Viking. I'm probably sure we'll be seeing them again in the future. Thanks, guys, for listening to Tats and Tats.